Obamacare has only been partially put into place in the last 2 years, and already the average premium has doubled. Well, now it's being reported by CNS News another double-digit premium increase is about to hit. How do you distract the public from double-digit black unemployment, from massive increases in crime in major U.S. cities for the first time in 20-plus years? Those numbers are now out. How do you distract from the incredible destruction of all Americans' basic freedoms? You activate and literally brainwash, to quote the former attorney general, the public through the media to obsess on racial divisions, and you fan the flames and rub salt in the wound. At the same time, you confuse gender identity and set the precedent for government bureaucrats, educators, and also medical workers to sexualize your children. We've got major breaking news on that front today. But the story is up on DrudgeReport.com on the right-hand side with the graphic white people. New MTV show publicly shames white people for what they've done in America. And this is a Soviet-style truth and reconciliation style show like they had in South Africa. I was against apartheid, but not the communist system that took it over and now made South Africa even worse, from one evil to an even greater evil. Well, it's the same thing here. This is pure Soviet Truth and Reconciliation Commission stuff with a bunch of 15-year-olds crying about their guilt. Guilt about we've hurt the earth, so pay Al Gore carbon tax. Guilt about how you've hurt the black people. Simply amazing, this level of brainwashing. We're going to play the trailer for the show and more, but this is Sumner Redstone, Viacom through Nickelodeon and MTV, sexualizing children. Remember, Viacom 5-6 years ago admitted in a corporate press release they were going to target preteens with transgender and homosexual messages. It's pedophilia. I mean, imagine saying, we're going to target your kids with heterosexual sex messages when they're 6 years old. You'd be like, that's pedophilia. Keep your hands off our kids. When Calvin Klein shows, you know, 15, 16-year-olds scantily clad, they call it pedophilia. It's creepy, but not really that. But when you target 5- or 6-year-olds, and it's the gay agenda, then it's okay to teach them how to do stuff I didn't even know about till I was an adult. I mean, it is just Twilight Zone level. But because they're able to do this, they're not insane. They're not whacked out like conservative media calls them, like they're some fringe. These people run the country. And it's not even your general, quote, gay person out there. Let's make that clear. They've just picked something to confuse society and to create another balkanization. And if they can teach 5-, 6-, 7-, 8-year-olds how to masturbate, how to give oral sex, this type of stuff, they can do anything. Joe Biggs has a report. He just did the interview before the show that we'll have either towards the end of the broadcast today or the nightly news tonight, where they are going in to 3-year-old, 5-year-old, 6-year-old, 7-year-old children at Texas hospitals and Texas doctor's offices, closing the door. They're not just asking about, does daddy have a gun? What's in mommy's medicine cabinet under Obamacare? It's all computerized. They ask the little girl, do you like to wear a dress? Do you think you're a boy? Does your mommy tell you it's okay if you want to be a boy? And then they say to the little boy, would you like to wear a dress? I mean, this is freak show stuff to get your kid in a database to bring the state in, mark my words, and take kids away, saying we're going to free them, we're going to let them, we're going to let your boy wear a dress and your girl be a boy.
When you say white, what does that mean to you?
We've never had to internalize what white people have done in America, but here you can't escape that.
Feels like I'm being discriminated against. You kind of get this feeling that things belong to you.
I'm getting uncomfortable. It's uncomfortable.
Hey, this is great. Let's get all uncomfortable together.
And the show is hosted by an illegal alien. I'm Alex Jones. I'm your host. Thank you so much for joining us on the syndicated radio / TV transmission. New MTV show publicly shames white people for what they've done in America. White People documentary hosted by illegal immigrant features young Americans crying over their white privilege. MTV will air a show later this month entitled White People, which shows young white Americans crying on camera over their white privilege and publicly shaming them, this is quoting the show, for what they've done in America. This is the opposite of the culture Martin Luther King talked about. This is where everything is you have guilt because you're white and you're inherently bad, pure racism. But anyone of color, 93% of the world population, is a saintly god devoid of criminal activity to the point of media will then not report or is told not to report when things are racially motivated, when it is committed by a majority minority. And this is all being invoked because the system has to distract the public from the fact that offshore crime cartels, private banking cartels, are dismantling what's left of free countries across the Western world and deliberately bankrupting cultures and societies. No, this is not a joke. The documentary is hosted by Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist Jose Antonio Vargas, who's an illegal alien, by the way, an illegal immigrant and amnesty activist who has worked for the Washington Post and the Huffington Post. See, we have a subversive offshore banking cartel that's just playing everyone off against each other. And I know that I am stating the obvious here, but it's so seditious what's going on. The trailer for the show, which has been widely criticized by YouTube respondents, features white people expressing angst about how they are desperate not to appear racist or offend people. So again, this is the mental illness they're giving people to be total basket cases. Oh, my God, I have a brown bag. Oh, my God, I'm white. Oh, my God, I did good on my test scores. It's because I'm inherently bad. Oh, my gosh, what do I do to prove I'm not bad? And they come in and they say, we'll tell you what you do. You support everything the government says and everything the mainstream media says, and you submit culturally day to day to whatever the changing directives are. You have no opinions, no views, except what we say, and you regurgitate them exactly as we say, and then we might say you're an okay person. You may have heard of this throughout history before. It's called cult programming. This is literal brainwashing, just like the former attorney general came out years ago addressing the Radio Television Film Association and said we need to, quote, literally brainwash the public every day, every minute with anti-gun messages. Well, it's the same thing. Every day, every minute, white people are bad, white people are evil, white people are the problem, white people, white people, white people. And this is all being directed and run by a bunch of rich media people that just so happen to be white who want a class war based on race, not based on their billions and trillions. So they want to invoke class war and race war to bring in totalitarianism as the solution and then securing their ill-gotten gains. It's scientifically crafted. The trailer for the show, which has been widely criticized on YouTube respondents, features white people expressing angst about how they are desperate not to appear racist or offend people. According to Kimberly Reese, the documentary forces the participants to internalize what they've done in America. So you're guilty, you're racist, your identity, your culture, your religion, your world is not that you're into music or into literature or a medical person or a social worker or a farmer or an artist or a lover of science fiction or a lover of gardening. It's all about how you look, so that it's never about what you actually stand for. This is a new dark age being brought in, where you're a heretic if they say you are for any reason. You don't want to turn your guns in, you're a racist. You don't support Obamacare, written by foreign insurance companies, you're a racist. Don't want to submit to the agenda, don't want to pay higher taxes, don't want to live in a 250-square-foot coffin apartment, you're anti-Earth, you want to kill the Earth. Don't want your children taken over by the state with the litmus test of asking your six-year-old, would they like to identify as a girl if they're a boy? Or would they like to identify as a boy if they're a girl? And do mommy and daddy let you identify like you want? And the kid's like, what's this mean? Well, let us teach you. Here's a little brochure. Then your child has this new power to become sexualized with outsiders that have come in and to demand from their parents that they go be with the outsiders to learn the new sexual ways. This is, give us your kids, bring them outside. This is hardcore pedophile takeover. I mean, look at these articles. They have troops in the U.S. Army wearing red high heels in public. School kids told. School kids told to not call themselves boys and girls because that hurts someone's feelings. You think this is insanity. This is going over the top. No, no, this is the new culture. This will be enforced. National Review, school kids told to call kids purple penguins because boys and girls is not inclusive to transgender. And then the elementary kids go, what's transgender? And they go, let us tell you. We're not going to teach you about the Federal Reserve. We're not going to teach you about reading, writing, and arithmetic. We're not going to teach you about pocketbook or checkbooks or how to balance your budget. We're not going to teach you how to garden. We're not going to teach you how to cook food. We're not going to teach you anything of any worth. We're not going to teach you sewing. We're not going to teach you typing. We're not going to teach you anything that would make you self-sufficient. You're going to learn that white people are bad. You're going to learn that men wear red high heels. You're going to learn how to give oral sex. You're going to learn. You're going to learn. You're going to learn. This is a scientific takeover. Look at this. Gender identity curriculum angers parents in Virginia. School children in elementary taught that they could be a transvestite. California lets grade schoolers decide gender identity. The kids aren't even talking about this. The kids, it's literally less than 1% of the population, but it's being injected with your children. And if they can get away with this with your kids, they can do anything. That's why this was chosen. As I said, Jocelyn Elders 20-something years ago sounded crazy saying, take elementary students in, turn the lights off, show them how to masturbate in school. People said that's crazy. Now that's normal. They've moved the Overton window. They've conditioned us with our normalcy bias. You have found it, the tip of the spear, independent grassroots radio / TV. It's all live, teleprompter free. And I think it makes the show even better that every once in a while we have a train wreck here on the broadcast. And that's because this is live. This is real. This is seat of your pants, telling the truth. Not a bunch of teleprompter writers filling out a script for me to follow. This is just real research, real guest, real calls, real information. Now, again, words cannot describe how weaponized the media is now and how weaponized the culture is. This was never about bringing in equality. They're always going to find some new group, the bestiality people, the pedophiles. The UN is openly accepting NAMBLA for more than 30 years as an official member, calling for the legalization. If your 10-year-old decides to get in the back of a bus with some pot-bellied 50-year-old man, your boy or your girl, it's their right, because the fat pedophile convince them that they wanted to have sex with them, that's now okay and you have nothing to say about it. See, that's not next. That's already here. And you are a pedophile phobe. You are a beastophobe. And it's about anything goes to break your will. All across the United States, school children are told, do not call each other boys and girls or say, can I go to the boys' room? Saying you're a boy hurts someone who isn't a boy. Saying you're a girl hurts someone who isn't a girl. Wearing an American flag hurts the immigrants' feelings. And then your parents and the school tell you to submit, and they relish submitting to it. They relish the tyranny. It's their culture. It's what they know. They're good at submitting. They're good at going and getting three rounds of student loans to never have a job from the degrees. They're good at dressing as they're told. White people in this country are the problem to a great extent, but not in the way the media says. Submissive, groveling, politically correct cult members. They're not liberals. They're not fascist. The globalists are fascist above them, using socialism and communist systems to control and domesticate. But that's an old phase. Now it's cult brainwashing. And when I say that, that's not rhetoric. This you're watching 21st century CIA Tavistock Institute declassified culture scrambling death. I mean, the elite put 300 chemicals, in some cases over 200 on average, in our water, not just hydrofluorosilicic acid. Cancer viruses and all the major vaccines on record. They want to kill us. And in the science fiction nightmare dystopic movie we live in, where the old world's being phased out, that was the good, the bad, and the ugly, and the new synthetic world that is the vision of some interstellar demon, for all I know, because it's so insane. With straight faces, they sit there in the cult. How do you think in cults they have a big stage and the leader of the cult and people agreeing with them saying, now take your baby up and throw it into the fire before Moloch so the crops grow? And the establishment says, kambuga shaka munda, kunga kingo, buga laka, bluga blah, 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 blah. And the witch doctors throw some chemicals that they've dug out of the mines their slaves have into the fire, and blue and orange fire from the sulfur goes, and they go, and then you bring your baby up and you throw it on the fire. And it writhes in pain and pops, and its eyes pop out of its head, and everybody dances around, and they tell the villagers that just sacrificed, you know, 27 of their firstborn in one village in the entire, you know, for the full moon ritual, that you've done well to the god. And then you move across the world at the same time to the Aztecs and the Toltecs and the Umecs and all the rest of the groups. This is the exact same thing going on. Burning, throwing children in water, cutting hearts out, hanging the bodies up. The priest class made their money off selling the luscious meats. And this is the cult of government. And the UN, in its biological diversity assessment in 96, had an addendum that we cover in the film Endgame 2.0, where they say in there, we will bring back all the tribal rituals. We will first destroy all culture and then rebuild it as pagan with human sacrifice. And this is where it's going. But first, they got to get you to accept creepy weirdos at the school telling your six-year-old how to, well, you know how to do.
We're what? On the march.
Something the hooker's doing on the side of the road. Oh, look, illustrating how the technotronic system's taking over. My phone was off. It's something that just started happening. And it just turned on a minute ago and forced a federal Amber Alert over it. And at first, these Amber Alerts were missing child, missing old lady, Alzheimer's patient. This is for Alice, Texas Amber Alert, 2009 White Dodge Avenger. But again, all that does is set the precedent that the federal government takes over communications. And now they put anti-gun messages over here. They put up anti-gun messages on the Amber Alert billboards. They put environmental brainwashing messages up. Now California says they're going to come out with license plates that are TV screens that put out government messages and wanted posters. But not to stop criminals. I mean, they've released 36,000 violent, aggravated felon, illegal aliens in the last 12 months alone who run around committing crime after crime. Why not? They're above the law. And then if Donald Trump dare talk about it, the media says, why'd he say all Hispanics were criminals? Why'd he say they're lazy? Why'd he say they hate him? Because he didn't say that. But they don't care. They misrepresent everything. Why is Alex Jones racist, hardball ask, and the Washington Post asked, and a bunch of other newspapers this week? He doesn't like the black president. He says martial law is coming, and Obama will take the guns in July and August. It's a triple lie. We never said it was martial law coming in those months. We said it was conditioning. It has nothing to do with Obama, the front man at the end of the day, and what color he is. And then the triple lie is they don't even show any proof where I say it. They've gone pure evil. In fact, when I watch CNN or MSNBC now, my mouth is hanging open because it is so 1984. I mean, it's so over the top, but this is what it looks like. 21st century, hardcore, the most vicious weaponized media, psychiatrists, psychologists, PR pitch people, DARPA brain scientists can come up with. I mean, it is hardcore. Imagine 20 years ago, if you heard in the future they would make the new Army recruits across the board go out in public in uniform wearing red high heels. And again, it's just to say, get on the ground and lick my boots. Why do tyrants throughout history make you lick their boots? Or Satanists make you do something else to the high priest to totally submit. It's a family show, but I don't want to go into all of it. And the next, it's kill kids. It's all about you will do what you're told, and when I say jump, you're going to say, yes, sir, master, how high? So, kids, we don't say the word boys and girls anymore. Imagine the cult, otherworld craziness of that. We don't say boys and girls. Boys and girls are the species in insects, in fish, in amphibians, in mammals. Boys and girls are the biological life. Again, if I was aliens that had taken the planet over and made a deal with the government that they could survive if they went along with this, I would come in and put chemicals in the water to screw up the hormones, and then as the hormone systems kicked in to confuse sexuality, I would begin to basically end reproductive activity on the planet to phase out the population without damaging the resources. It's a biological neutron bomb. I mean, this is so evil. That's why I say, just at an instinctive level, it looks alien. And I've just got to be honest with you. I'm not saying aliens are doing it. I'm not saying they're running it. I just want to ask everybody at Media Matters that write disinformation pieces on us every couple days, directed by the White House on record. I want to ask the White House employees something. You know, you really did fund ISIS and Al-Qaeda to run around and kill hundreds of thousands of innocent people and destabilize and overthrow countries that were helping Africa and the Middle East and that weren't even enemies of the United States. You know, fluoride in the water really does cause IQ reduction and brain damage, and that's even admitted by Harvard. You know, all of this racial division really is meant to get us all at each other's throats and control us. And I mean, I just want the mid-level minions to realize, do you understand you've signed on to pure evil? I mean, going in and asking 6-year-olds, when they go to the doctor, how do you sexually orient yourself? You don't see how that's cultic. You don't see how that's about the state being able to do whatever they want with kids and ending parental consent. You don't see forced inoculations in California as draconian? You don't see big banks that run this whole show selling the same house, the same mortgage, sometimes more than 50 times and not getting in trouble? I mean, do you really, at an instinctive level, feel good about what you're doing? Do you really feel like this is going to help you and your family, or do you not know it's going to come back on you? I mean, do you not, at an instinctive level, fear this? You can't say you're boys and girls. You're now all purple penguins. We've had different gay. See, they say don't use the word homosexual. Use the word gay. You do that. Now it's, okay, don't say boy or girl. Say purple penguin. So you do something to be friendly, to be nice, and then do more, do more, do more, until you're a total slave to whatever you're told. I've had many times gay activists here at these offices because they're exposing Agenda 21, or they're exposing some issue, and they'll tell you, by the way, I'm gay. By the way, I'm a lesbian. I'm like, yeah, I knew that. Yeah, okay, back to the issue of this thing. No, I want to talk about how I'm a lesbian or how I'm gay. You notice I'm wearing purple. You don't mind if I wear purple on your show. And I just go, no, I what does purple mean? Well, that's the merger of the color blue for boys and pink for girls. Because, and again, and I go, oh, yeah, I've read about that. You know that's actually the end of sex, to be asexual, Brave New World. They're like, oh, you don't like it. And I'm like, you don't know. You've already been taught to the trendiest thing is to not be a sex, because they're going to chemicalize us where we aren't a sex. THX1138. And it just over the head. I mean, like, I care what you do in your bedroom, but don't force this rewrite of all language on me when it's a psych warfare admitted Pentagon eugenics program. Let me put it to you this way. Let me say this to the folks up at Media Matters and at Raw Story and everywhere else, you know, out there that write the White House line, Salon, all of you. Because I don't care that you attack me and lie about me. People know it's not true. It's that I really fear for you at a fundamental level. You do understand that they have death panels. You do understand they're putting troops on do not treat list all over the country. Joe Biggs has been to the VA more than 20 times in Austin, big giant facility. There aren't even lines. And they just say, bring your file back. We have to run your paperwork. And then just always say, bring your file back. We have to do your paperwork. It comes back the next day. Bring your file back. And they just laugh at him. He's on a list. They look at the computer. They look back and they go, we're not accepting people. Just get out of here. Next person walks right up. You're accepted. Because if you're a radio operator, nothing is radio operators, or if you were in supply, they're not really worried about you that much. But if you're a combat vet and they've got you in a database that you're not going along with the system, you're just not getting treated. Now, it came out that a IBM supercomputer system called Watson, there's a whole bunch of these computers, there's thousands of them, but they're called Watson, named after Thomas Watson, the number one Nazi of the United States, bigger than Henry Ford, given the highest level award, above awards Hitler was given. They had to make a new award for him. It was an Iron Cross with four eagles. Look it up. He invented the machines that they put the Hollerith cards in to decide when to feed you, when to kill you, what to do. And the Nazis could say at Nuremberg, we didn't kill anybody. The computer said it, and they had as many as 5,000 IBM technicians in Germany during World War II. Watson reportedly the first few years would sneak in and out of Germany, out of Spain, just like Henry, just like Edward VIII, the King of England would do. And I'm not saying it's a Nazi conspiracy. The Nazis were just like a test run or a bad son or a spinoff or a mini-me. Nazi Germany was a mini-me. About 3 feet tall compared to an 18-foot devil. That's the New World Order. I mean, we're talking, you ain't seen nothing. The EU was a Nazi program. how to put poison in the food, genetically engineer it, all a Nazi plan to poison the countries they conquered for a few decades, then to have national health care to process the dead. You never even know why you're being killed. All you people that are working for the system, man, don't you know you just signed on to just stuff so evil you can't even imagine it. So, now they've got the Watson computers, named after the guy who ran the computers that ran the death camps that they put the tattoo numbers in. And they're doing it to the vets. They never reformed it because it's by design, and we sit here and take it. Why not? Kill 54 million babies. Put the troops on don't treat list. Kill old people. Bill Gates already taught the socialists out there, hey, we can hire 10 teachers if we kill grandma. And some of the teachers rubbed their hands together at the meeting and went, ooh, yeah, I get something if we kill somebody. Soft, weak government employees who've never lived in the real world to a great extent. I'm not saying all of them, but those groups actually thinking Bill Gates is going to bring in a system to kill people and then they're going to get more resources. They've decided to scale back humanity to nothing. We'd have to keep our numbers the same so you could just live the same level. When they reduce numbers, it destroys the economy. You are going to be destroyed too, idiots. You have no empathy, you're narcissistic, you're entitled, you're weak-minded, and you think this devil system is going to take care of you. So let's get this straight. This is not liberal insanity. This is not whacked out environmentalist. All these conservative terms, like it's a joke. The Pope's called for a world government and carbon taxes and a world government based on wealth redistribution with the bankers tax exempt above it all, administering it. Animal Farm on steroids. 1984 on steroids. And they've got the troops wearing red high heels. They've got the kids saying we're purple penguins, no boys and girls. They got boys going in the girls' restroom, girls going in the boys. They've got bedlam with these cold-blooded sharks behind armored fortresses with their mistresses and their boyfriends and their helicopters and their jets sitting on top of the greatest wealth the world's ever seen, sitting back. I mean, is the Pope calling for its tens of trillions held in the Vatican alone to be distributed to the poor? Oh, no. Oh, no, no. He just wants you to pay a carbon tax to the ultra-rich banks. And he goes around with Obama. He's going to come address the Congress here in September. And they're going to set up platforms all around the Capitol for all the socialists to come worship and communists their new god. And I can take you there. I got a brand new god. Brand new God. And will this God deliver? Did Obamacare deliver? Hell no. Did the open borders deliver? Hell no. Did all the tyranny deliver? Oh, but don't worry. They have an illegal alien flaunting it, hopping around, just rubbing America's face in it. Your kids are purple penguins. The troops wear red high heels. I'm an illegal alien on TV with a bunch of sappy, weak white kids with trendy socialist parents up here flogging themselves about how bad they are. Just, you ever seen those stickers where somebody's a Ford and they're peeing on a Chevy or vice versa? I mean, that's it. You're down on the ground. And right in your face, they're just going to teach you to take it all. Unbelievable. And you ain't seen nothing yet. Let's go to this video clip. Paul Watson is joining us in 30 minutes, 40 minutes, to break it down at the bottom of the next hour. And then Joe Biggs has the interview in Texas doctor's offices. You bring in your daughter and your son. They go, man, will you talk to him alone? Thank you. You want to identify as another sex, little girl? What's that mean? You ever feel like a boy? Does your mom wear pants? She like a man? Bring the boy in now. You want to be a little girl? I mean, imagine you're at the park. Some old guy walks over and goes, hey, little girl. You feel like a boy sometimes? But see, now it's the school, so it's loving. It's prove yourself. Sacrifice your children to the system. Take the shots. Eat the GMO. Go to McDonald's. Drink the fluoride. And then let the creepy doctor, who's a social warrior and proud of themselves, stopping the inequality, breaking it down with your child. It's their child now. We've got to break through this idea that kids belong to their parents. No, now the kids belong to all of us. Lean forward. And she's got a cult look in her eye, like all the other cult videos you've seen. Their eyes get real saucer. Lean forward. A Karl Marx term. Knowing the public can't even find their butt with both hands, doesn't know what Independence Day is, doesn't know what cult programming is. Do you understand, folks? This is cult programming. This isn't liberal. This isn't conservative. This is freak show. See, they have to bring down the military. That'll be their final enemy. The military will help bring the tyranny in, and then it will be destroyed. Because before the rise of the machines and the merger with the elite, and the life extension system, before that can happen, they have to take out men. Men in the womb are selected genetically from a female prototype to be a combat mechanism and a hunting mechanism to defend the nesting areas. It's like that in almost all mammal and bird species. This is an attack on the species. Once they've taken the men down, which they've basically already done, the machines, the AI, all the appliances, everything, it's just over. So just, I warned you, I tried my best, and if you allow them to sexualize your 5 and 6-year-olds, they've won. It's a litmus test, the gauntlet's here, and they've got white people on MTV going, I'm evil, I'm sorry. I mean, what a freak show. They have to destroy the family. They have to destroy all independent cultures. They have to override it with a culture of servile submission to whatever the new edict is. Not to create a world of utopian hippies. That's what they tell their minions. But to create a world ready to be overridden. Ready to be conquered by the super technologies that have already been developed. And anyone out there serving this system consciously, you need to understand, you're delusional. You're a useful idiot. You have Stockholm Syndrome. I mean, do you really want to sign on to IBM supercomputers making the criminal decision to not give veterans care? Humans are being removed from the decision-making process. Already, many news articles and press releases are written by a CIA program that was partially declassified 4 years ago. Notice they're getting rid of the media corps now. They don't need it. They'll soon have hologram media corps individuals that go out and present the info. And you say, that's crazy. That'll never happen. They want it to be crazy. They want to invert reality and break your will. This is a military operation. And I'll tell the military something as well. And all the brass I talk to already know this, high level. The next war will be against the vets. It's already being prepared. And against any type of esprit de corps culture. Because it's not going to be there. You're going to have technicians and basically technician centers that work on robots and computers and automated systems when they're needed in the next phase. No more humans, period. And the argument is, we'll take out the Chinese interceptor missiles with our new aircraft that can do maneuvers because they're unmanned. But they're also autonomous. You can say, well, that's just where this is going. Yes, and the decision's been made to get rid of 7 billion people. Meanwhile, while we face this threat, Memphis City Council has approved the plan to dig up Confederate General. No word yet of American flag will also be removed since it follows the same logic. Kit Daniels, Infowars.com. General Nathan Bedford Forrest. I mean, this is mental illness, folks. This is mental illness. And imagine, you think we can hold this back? Not if we don't take our kids back away from them. Or at least explain to them the brainwashing that it's okay to be a boy or be a girl. I mean, imagine a kid. It's okay I'm a boy or a girl? Yes, you're not hurting someone's feelings. I'm going to play it when we start the next hour. If you just tuned in, it's up on Infowars.com. It's top linked on the right-hand side of DrudgeReport.com. New MTV show publicly shames white people for what they've done in America. Documentary hosted by an illegal. It's all coming up. Movie explores white privilege. Well, let's explore with the illegal alien from Mexico why Mexico's collapsing and the elite privilege there of the folks that, I mean, you go look at the Mexican Congress, it's all like 6'4" people that are whiter than me. But they're all the ones pushing the white privilege thing because it's insane, ladies and gentlemen. You still have colonialism basically down in Mexico, and then it's all about how white people are evil here. Oh, guess what? Even the Washington Post has been demonizing us, admits. Other domestic military training operations with special forces have been public, but they're not allowed now to see what's going on with Jade Helm, even though they've been told they could, and they claim they're scaling it down basically 90% from more than 20,000 support troops, 10,000 special forces troops. They're now scaling it down to 1,200. I don't believe any of it. Jade Helm is just a larger conditioning process, and now it's just become a psyop to then claim that we said it was imminent martial law, and then it doesn't happen. And the new thing is we're all racist. Press blackout during domestic troop training. Must protect identity of forces involved. Yeah, from the enemy. But media access granted in the past. So that's all coming up. And then Paul Watson joins us at the bottom of the hour. Watch the uncomfortable trailer for MTV's documentary, White People. That's Entertainment Weekly. About white people apologizing for the evil of being white. I mean, total racism. Imagine a show where black people that haven't done anything get up there and apologize for blacks attacking whites and racial crimes that are many more times more common than whites doing it. And that's just a fact. But see, that's racist to state a fact. But see, the black person, the average black person isn't to blame for what a racist black person does. And I'm not to blame for what another white person does. But the essence of totalitarianism is many things. But in that soup of stench is the guy five doors down shot at one of the security forces. We're going to take you all away for re-education now and rape your wife. Oh, someone shot an SS officer. We're going to kill 500 people in the town. We're going to put them inside a church and light the church on fire and shoot with machine guns anybody tries to come out. That was what Heinrich, what was his name? No, Heinrich Himmler was the head of the SS and the chicken farmer, and Hitler was obsessed with him because he was royal. Heinrich something, the blonde beast, he got assassinated, I think it was in Croatia, got shot out of the back of the car he was in, and that was his thing. He'd go around everywhere, and people started, especially in Serbia and places, they were shooting all the SS officers, because in Serbia they didn't back down, with a few countries that didn't, and there was Reinhard Heinrich, the blonde beast, yeah. And I just love the fact, like, 2 weeks after he'd gone through all these towns and killed all these people because they kept shooting at him, they killed him. See, your intimidation tactic didn't work, jerk. And see, what they found is, but don't worry, NATO got you back for saving the father of the Clinton Secretary of State, Madeleine Albright. They bombed Belgrade and killed a bunch of people, so I guess the Nazis did win. But in the end, I mean, when you first don't succeed, try again. But these tactics don't work. But if they can teach kids when they're five that a boy's a girl's a boy, saying boys and girls is hurtful, so you're now purple penguins and have special forces troops wear red high heel shoes in public and teach six-year-olds that their mommy is bad because she didn't put the son in a dress, that's in the news today. Then you're hateful. You'll have such screwed up basket cases. They won't know how to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich or do the laundry. But believe me, they will know all about being obsessed over their wee-wee. I mean, this is mental illness. This is mass mental illness by design. And if you're a new listener and just tuned in, I'm not kidding. Here's the headline. School told to call kids purple penguins because boys and girls is not inclusive to transgender. See, being white in and of itself is not inclusive. You understand? If you're straight, if you happen to like women and you're a man, that's not inclusive. You must accept. You must be transabled. You must chop your arms and legs off. That's where all this goes. You must be scuttled. Larry Nichols will do his part three interview with us, The Secrets of Hillary Clinton, and he's going to dish intel never before released from his perspective. He has more on what we already know Hillary's up to. And it's important you understand the personal modus operandi of this literal witch. Literal. Coming up with Larry Nichols in the third hour. And it actually has come out in the news that she would go to a weird occult church in California and go in there routinely. Tony Blair's wife was in major British papers as a witch who helped him become possessed by the spirit of light. And Tony Blair flops around on the ground every morning. I'm not joking. He's proud of it. And is possessed by the spirit of the light. And then he travels the world like François Mitterrand did, the former French president, to be possessed by different spirits, Aztec temples, other areas. I mean, these people are crazy, okay? These people are nuts. And it's just really part of the Twilight Zone landscape with the Pope calling for world government, global carbon taxes, to address Congress for the first time ever, any Pope in 239 years of U.S. history in September. World government being announced everywhere. Here's just some of the headlines coming up. IMF lowers global growth forecast, cites U.S. weakness. Our fault, of course. And continuing, Jade Helm 15 heavily scrutinized military exercise to open without media access. Washington Post. Oh, isn't that interesting? Isn't that special? Coming up, as I mentioned, a new MTV show publicly shames white people for what they've done in America. We're going to break that down and tie it in with all of the brainwashing news that we've got to cover. And then we're going to get into a map of over 200 sanctuary cities in 32 states and D.C. It's actually 800 plus, but Examiner has 200 of them listed, where you're allowed to commit crimes and are then released. Simply over the top, a double-digit premium hike, request signal, start of Obamacare death spiral. It's already doubled the last 2 years. Now the insurance companies are going and saying, we want to basically have a double-digit increase yet again, because you would cut your prices. And well, first it's going to be free, and then cut your prices, and then you can keep your doctor. But you know what? My memory's racist. It's not that foreign insurance companies wrote this with the Republicans to screw us over, just like TPP. It's not that both parties are working together at the top. That's not why I don't like it. It's not that it massively increased my insurance, or I just tried to change my insurance and I'm having trouble doing it because of Obamacare. It's not that it caps my employees at 50. It's not that we might have to lay people off because of it. No, it's because he's black and I'm bad. And when kids are having a party at my house, I'll say, come on, boys and girls, the ice cream truck just got here. Because I'll get an ice cream truck to come sometimes when my kids have a party with 100 kids. We had P. Terry's once with hamburgers. And I'll say, come on, boys and girls, see, it's my sexism. Because the word boy or girl is hurtful to transgender. They're probably right there hearing. It's not enough to say, come on, boys, girls, and transgendered, and transabled, and those that identify as a dog. It's because I'm bad, and those that tell me I'm bad, they have a moral authority. They don't have jobs. They don't do anything. Their job is sitting around telling us how we're bad and why there's stained glass windows in the National Cathedral that show the South surrendering, and there's a little battle flag there because, you know, it's like a photograph. They're now talking about erasing photographs in history books like Stalinist Russia. I'm not kidding. That's in the news because kids might see a photo of a rebel flag. Next, we can't even have Nazi flags in movies. Schindler's List. Remove them. Just seeing the image is bad. And then again, brown paper bags. We're just seeing it everywhere. This is a black table, and I put my elbows on it. It's a symbol of dominating the black people. I'll never forget, I was taking video class like 20 years ago at Access TV. One of the best values ever. It was a couple hundred bucks, a couple weeks class, and then I knew basic stuff. And I remember the teacher was Hispanic, and he was sitting up there, and he was going, well, this is how you desaturate the whites, and this is how you crush the blacks. That's what you're doing on the processor. That's the technical term. And he goes, but we probably shouldn't say that. Because his accent was like a Native American accent. He goes, it's probably not good to say to crush the blacks because someone might get their feeling hurt. I mean, this is like total mental illness, political correctness. I've told you the stories repeatedly where somebody goes, let's get Mexican food. Hey, let's go eat. Yeah, Mexican. I mean, hey, watch that. I'm saying Mexican. I was at Barton Springs 2 years ago, laying out, just swam 2 miles. And I'm sitting there on my elbows, and I see two Hispanic guys and a white guy right in front of me in the shallow end, and they're obviously baked out of their brain, stoned. They're like, man, I'm hungry, yeah. Let's go get Chinese food. And the guy goes, dude, you're not supposed to call it that. It's Asian. And sure enough, now in yoga classes and stuff where they teach some of this other Eastern stuff, they go, we don't call it the Chinese New Year. We call it the Lunar New Year. And now in Austin, when they have big billboards, big city-run billboards for holidays, it's now Lunar New Year. What? Now Mexican food, the word is racist. Chinese food, traditional American, soul food. They're now saying, "Don't." I'm serious, don't call it soul food, because, you know, it's not nice to say black people got soul. That's just what it's called in the South by black people, which all it is a traditional Southern food. My grandmother cooked the exact same thing that black people cook, because that's the food that was available, and it's tasty. The point is, it's mental illness projected on us where we don't know reading, writing, and arithmetic. We don't know how to do the laundry. Your kids don't know how to take, they just watch TV all day and learn how they can wear dresses. So we're going to go over all of that with Paul Watson coming up at the bottom of the hour. But since I mentioned it, look, this is the new flagellation. Beat yourself. Say you're horrible. Talk about mental illness. A bunch of crying. I was white and I had bad feelings and I such and such. And I've never felt and seen such racial tension in my entire life. And I grew up in Dallas, Texas, that had a lot of racial tension. It has just been injected to make everyone uncomfortable so that we're all mindlessly fighting with each other or worrying about what the other person thinks or trying to prove that we're not. I'll do whatever I'm told, media. In fact, that's what they say in the newscast about this. It's like, you know, these kids will do anything not to prove, you know, not to be racist. I'll do whatever you say. I'll support anything you say. Jade Helm, let the troops train to take on the Tea Party. Yes, train to take on the veterans. Yes, yes, triple my health care costs. Yes, take my guns. Yes, open the borders. Yes, I'll pay for Chinese women to pour in at record levels to have their babies for free because I don't want to be called racist because there's nothing worse. And if you are now, you lose your job, you get arrested. I mean, what are we going to do? There's racists everywhere. It's worse than terrorism. Al-Qaeda is under the table. Please grow up my genitals, TSA. Meanwhile, the government runs Al-Qaeda, runs the Taliban, runs all these major organizations on record. This is psych warfare. This is how you screw people up. And I just see leftists walking around everywhere, downtown. And they're just, I mean, you hear them. Yeah, it's Donald Trump's really getting it. Conservatives are kooks. Yeah, aren't we smart? Oh, my gosh. Yeah, You'll be in restaurants. You hear them all like a cult going, oh, my gosh, that kook, that funny guy. These conservatives just don't get it. Oh, yeah. Oh, I tell you, my friend really stands up for transgender. And they are just really, I'm just so proud of them. And it's just, it's a cult. I mean, I used to go to this Methodist church sometimes in Austin, Texas, because they used to have a pretty good preacher back when Bush was in, and they were truly anti-war, and it was classical liberal. That guy got retired, and, man, they brought in a husband and wife team to get up there, man, and it is Bill Gates. It controls the planet. The borders must be opened. The cross must be taken down. I mean, it is just hardcore. Hardcore. I mean, it is like a Soviet re-education camp. What do you think a re-education camp is? It's TV screens, brainwashing you, seeing who'll side, seeing who'll peer pressure go along. It's like a big high school with hazing and harassment. It's like West Point hazing that just goes on for years. But it's not seeing if you'll break and do what you're told. It's seeing who will rat, who will be an operative, who will be an informant, who will turn on their family, who will break, and who's got to be sent to another base to be killed. And all of America is a giant re-education camp. So is Europe. Let's go to this clip called White People, the new trailer. Here it is.
When you say white, what does that mean to you?
We've never had to internalize what white people have done in America, but here, you can't escape that.
Feels like I'm being discriminated against. You kind of get this feeling that things belong to you.
I'm getting uncomfortable. It's uncomfortable.
Hey, this is great.
This is truth and reconciliation communism. That's what this is, directly and hardcore. We'll be back. Stay with us. See, they started liberal political correctness on the surface as reasonable. It's how they always get you hooked. So that you don't hurt somebody's feelings, hey, this is the best way to approach something. And by the time they're done, oh, having boys and girls is hateful. We have to be asexual now and not use the word boy and girl. There's never a level you can attain. We've got to take the stained glass windows out that show the surrender at Gettysburg of the Southern forces, because there's a rebel flag there in the stained glass. Oh, we got to dig up Confederate generals out of cemeteries, because just them being in the grounds, hateful. This is all done, and again, I keep harping on this, so that we can be robbed blind by the globalist. While we're all busy fighting with each other, the Chinese stock market is still plunging. There's all these glitches that had airlines, newspapers, you name it, go down, hacker groups basically hinted they were about to do it. Was that a fake cyber attack to get Congress to go ahead and give unlimited power to Homeland Security over the web? I don't know. But everything is accelerating. You can feel it. You can see it. And then you get an illegal. And again, imagine if I was in Mexico lecturing people on TV about how Mexicans are bad, and then I could pick some stereotypical examples and sit there and lecture, and then Mexicans crying, I'm bad, you're right, thank you, from America telling me. I mean, it's asinine. No one would put up with this. Or someone from Germany here lecturing us. I mean, I made a film about Schwarzenegger. Well, part of the film, martial law, saying, how dare you from Austria be over here lecturing us about how to be a free country? Shut up, criminal. Is it because I hate Austrians? No. It's obscene. Jose Antonio Vargas, the host of the documentary White People, is a journalist, filmmaker, an immigration activist, a globalist, born in the Philippines and raised in the United States from the age of 12. He was part of the Washington Post team that won the Pulitzer Prize for breaking news reporting in 2008 for coverage of the Virginia Tech shootings. He's an anti-gunner. He wrote, produced, and directed the autobiographical 2013 Documented, which CNN filmed broadcast in 2014. And he pushes the DREAM Act to legal for the children legalized the people. And during the trailer, we'll show some of that video right now without audio if you're a TV viewer, bugging his eyes out at the white people. Say, how's it feel to be white, huh? And just the whole time acting super aggressive and angry. And then they all get intimidated. Yes, we're bad. We're sorry. I mean, I wish this guy would come to me. Because, hey, I am like Martin Luther King. I'm proud of myself. I bet you money. And Martin Luther King got beat up quite a few times by racist white people. I bet you money. I've been attacked by more black people than Martin Luther King's been attacked by white people. And the black people that attacked me were just like the white people that attacked him. They were racist, they were scum, and they thought it was okay to attack me because of my skin color. I'm like Martin Luther King. This guy's a race baiter. He's more akin to the other side of the debate, and I'm sick of it. And we've been given this guilt, so we'll submit to total tyranny. You see, I'm above you race pimps and you racists. And all you grand dragons in the Democratic Party and the rest of you scum, I really do care about everybody. I really do want to stop 52% of black people getting killed before they're born. I really do want to stop Latin American girls being sterilized in a UN program with Gardasil, which has now been proven to jack these women up. Because when they attack these innocent people, they're attacking me. I take it personal. I care about humanity, and I'm sick of you globalists following hardcore psych warfare programs meant to bring us down so we're all fighting with each other and they can bring the nation states down and bring in world government that's going to target everybody. The globalists are fighting as hard as they can in every nation, Africa, Latin America, Asia, to bring in GMO to hurt your people. And you'll never talk about the white liberal globalist eugenics program because it's got the Chinese leadership, the African leadership, and the Latin American leadership. They're all involved because what it really is rich crony capitalist insiders that are anti-free market and on a eugenics transhumanist science fiction power trip that they're going to live forever, and they're part of the inside club, only 6,000 superclass of every race, color, religion, and creed, and the Pope is part of it, pushing the whole agenda out in the open. And they are attacking everybody. It's 6,000 people against us. It's not the 1%. It's the 0000000 after the point 23. They're the ones that are using scientific warfare brainwashing. Once they get you under the guilt, they've got you, and then they can do anything they want. You'll submit to everything. Wake up, stop submitting, vomit up political correctness like the poison it is. Here's the bottom line. The general public has been mesmerized into a lower state of brain function. That's on record. Physical IQs are dropping from chemical warfare, biological warfare. On record, they all write books, how they're killing us. It's funny to them. They say, look how dumb the public is. We just wrote a book admitting we're doing it. And then they've got us all infighting and confused on every level. And they're moving forward teaching our six-year-olds they're racist and teaching them that they're bad if they say I'm a boy or a girl, that they should identify as a purple penguin. And this is at medical facilities. This is at schools. This is at doctor's offices. This is a unified takeover with minions throughout the system taking orders. Because under Obamacare, everything's computerized, and you're given specific directives if you take Medicare or Medicaid in any part of your practice that you will then read these scripts to the children. Well, the answer is don't comply. So I'm going to go over a whole list just today of what's in the news and then go to Paul Watson here in just a moment. First off, if you're not telling friends and family about this broadcast, you're crazy. This show understands what's happening. This information is not my opinion 99% of the time. I rarely speculate. We have our hand on the pulse, our finger on the pulse of the zeitgeist. We understand the plan. We know how to defeat it. We have to circumvent the whole thing and just come to grips with how evil the globalists are and break with their whole system on every front and shake people out of their political correctness. And that means mainline Republicans that have their own political correctness to follow the whole blue blood, country club Republican, racism light, we're the elite, real white privilege system that's just a whole nother diversion. But that itself is just an edifice that's merged with the Democratic Party. The Democratic Party is the tip of the spear. They're the juggernaut. They're the blitzkrieg. They're the frontline heavy armor rolling in. They're there to drive the cultural change towards anti-human measures, while the Republicans play the part of the opposition so that when you go to them, you can't ever get real change back towards reality. So there's a war on reality going on right now. There's a war on reality going on right now. There's a war on natural order, not be open to other people that wish to live differently or have different urges, but you must accept it. Your existence is bad. You must adopt it. You must tolerate. You must accept. You must adopt. And they pick radical things to make you adopt. It has nothing to do. They sat around in boardrooms 40 years ago. We even have university documents. Again, it's in my film, Endgame 2.0. It's technically called 1.5 because I was going to do a 2.0, but never did. It's actually 1.5. And they said, well, how do we do it? How do we break down the normal life cycle? How do we destroy the family? We've already gotten the women into work. And we now make their cultural development about men being a problem. We now make them think the species would be perfected if there weren't men, when that's actually the species is men and women together. And then we'll go into the asexual mode by the 2000s with the kids, and then in sexuality, saying that any sexual preference is hurtful to others, until any literature, any ideas, any information, any art is hurtful and bad. And now scores of what I'd call cooler liberals, kind of libertarian liberals like Joe Rogan's and Jerry Seinfeld's and just you name it. Most of the top comedians can't tell sex jokes. You know, Joe tells jokes about men. He tells jokes about women, about straight, about gay. And he gets a bunch of heat about it. Seinfeld can't even do mild jokes now. No one can. His daughter came to him. In fact, cue it up. I keep saying I'm going to play it for 2 weeks and haven't. And his 14-year-old daughter, they go, hey, let's move back to New York from the countryside so you can see more boys and have more friends. She went, boys is hateful to say the word boy or girl. And Seinfeld, you don't have to get it yet. I mean, later in the interview with Paul, just remind me. Seinfeld misinterpreted, there's the headline, Seinfeld, comedians avoid performing at politically correct colleges. Seinfeld, Jerry Seinfeld misinterpreted. He thought she just has no life experience and is ignorant and is doing her version of legitimate political correctness. No, Jerry, you've got the older politically correct download that sounded more reasonable to you to be, you know, have a nice society. You know, the Martin Luther King version. You got the old download, bro. Get 5 or 6 versions up. Purple penguins, bro. Purple penguins. Learn about them. These people are basket cases. I mean, I've been around, quote, gay and lesbian people, and a lot of people that are super cool, but ones that are politically correct, even that are libertarian or conservative, and they corner you and just keep going, I'm gay, I'm gay, I'm gay. And it's like, I mean, I don't care. See, that's a truly colorblind society or whatever. No, 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 no. It's just, it's a way to be in the center of attention, dominate you, and make you obsess over them, and somehow you're morally not good. It's like a spoiled, rotten 7-year-old tattling on their brother or sister when they haven't done anything. It is just arrested development insanity. And some of this isn't social engineering. When societies aren't challenged long-term, and I mean, prosperity makes monsters, adversity makes men, to quote Victor Hugo. I think I flipped it. It's adversity makes men, prosperity makes monsters. In Japan, the biggest selling thing is adult diapers. And of that subsection, it was even in Bloomberg, it's adults that like to poop on themselves. And I don't mean to be gross here, but Japan had a culture obsessed with cleanliness. They were the cleanest people in the world. And so that's the new deviance, and they've got a lot of shops and bars that are scatological. I don't mean to be gross. That's just what's going on. So see, in Japan, you rebel by being dirty. You understand? And here we have an elite that have a scientific method to all this, and they admit it's a plan. But at the same time, they're so disconnected that nothing gets them off anymore. So it's not enough for them to be perverse. Now they want to make us in their image. That's what any god does, is it makes its creation in its image. Well, they didn't make us. The globalists didn't make us, but they aspire to be gods. So now they want to basically project their twisted ideologies onto us while claiming they're gods and are going to merge with machines and live forever. You people are all going to kill each other. You think you're going to stop all this weirdness once you've got total control? You'll be given power for 1 hour. And I don't just say that because of the Bible. I've seen it. I've studied it. World government is going to come in. They're going to have the Hollywood, the Pope, every Protestant leader. Just they're all going to call for it. Billions are going to be killed in giant wars. You won't be able to buy or sell without. They're going to have vaccines that are already out that literally change your brain. God will forgive you. You know, if you get injected with this and lose your consciousness, your soul's still safe. But if it wasn't for God, even the elect would be deceived. I mean, this is going to be the. In fact, I used to think Revelation or whatever was like 100 years out. No, I'm wrong. I've been wrong. 5 years, 10 years, I don't know. I mean, 20 years, I don't know. And even if God isn't real, if you believe that, the archetype that we've created is going to destroy the planet. This wavelength of evil we see unfolding is planet killing. Every instinct I've got tells me that. And I want to explain that to folks. I want to go to Paul Watson with his breakdown of his article that's on DrudgeReport.com and PrisonPlanet.com that is just the latest. This is only the beginning. The more you submit, the more you whip yourself, the more you prostrate yourself, the more you beg, the more you plead, the more you do what they say, and please, I'll do whatever you say. Don't call me racist. The more you do that, the more you're going to be beaten down by mobs of brainwashed majority minorities who actually believe that they're doing something good to eradicate the enemy. Then the whites will run to the government, become real racist but closeted, join with the eugenics left, and help carry out the extermination of the poor across racial lines. Problem, reaction, solution. Three-dimensional chess, Hegelian dialectics. I've only given you a few levels of it. But be assured that's the plan. Now, here's Jerry Seinfeld not understanding what's going on. Here it is.
A lot of people tell me don't go near colleges. They're so PC. Hey, I'll give you an example. My daughter's 14. My wife says to her, well, you know, in the next couple of years, I think maybe you're going to want to hang around the city more on the weekends so you can see boys. You know, my daughter says, she says, that's sexist.
Isn't that, you know, it's amazing.
That, they just want to use these words. That's racist. That's sexist. That's prejudice. They don't even know what they're talking about.
Does it?
Now he's right.
Yes, it does.
At that low level, that the minions, the young, like to just use the power words, which the system rewards. But on top of it, no, she's not saying it because she's just ignorant. She is ignorantly spouting it. She's saying it because that's the programming. To say girls and boys like each other is bad. Do you understand? Look at these headlines. New MTV show publicly shames white people for what they've done in America. Gender identity curriculum angers parents in Virginia. They're asking their six-year-olds, would you like to be a boy or a girl? And then teaching them about it. U.S. Army forces cadets to wear high heels to promote feminist campaign. National Review, school told to call kids purple penguins because boys and girls is not inclusive to transgender. This is just out. Boehner wants review of Confederate symbols in U.S. Capitol. Memphis City Council approves plan to dig up Confederate General Nathan Bedford Forrest. Federal judge orders cancellation of Washington Redskins trademark. By the way, I'm told I'm related to Forrest. This is getting crazy by the minute. Continuing, Obama orders cities and towns to racially integrate. As if just some order. Federal judge orders cancellation of Washington Redskins trademarks. That's just some of the news. California lets grade schoolers decide gender identity. That's what you learn in school now. Does your mommy make you wear a dress? That's what doctors, we have this report coming up. Joe Biggs interviewed the mother. Does your mommy make you wear that dress? Do you want to wear that dress? How creepy. The government, through private agencies, you go pay, asking weird, creepy sexual questions about mommy and daddy to your kids. What a freak show country we are. And this is worldwide, from Australia to Germany, this is being done. They banned in Germany new construction of single-parent dwellings or single-family dwellings because it's hateful to have a family alone. You need to be in the community house. I mean, those of us that have read history or read dystopic novels, we know, God, this is like textbook hell. But see, the young don't know. They come home to their parents and go, I'm not a boy, I'm not a girl, I'm a purple penguin. All designed to go, I'm a purple, I'm a purple, I'm a purple penguin, purple penguin. Oregon allowing 15-year-olds to get state-subsidized sex change operations. And you're going to pay for it. And you're going to pay for abortions through Obamacare. Because this is the freedom while foreign banks loot your pension funds and they prepare paramilitary forces and replace the military with robots and prepare Homeland Security in their own documents to take on gun owners, veterans, and the South in some new civil war. That's in all the public documents. And then we go, hey, Jade Helm should be watched. Shut up, racist. Joining us now, I'm going to skip this network break, is Paul Joseph Watson. Paul, you wrote about this. For folks that think it isn't real, it's in Entertainment Weekly and other places. It's a real MTV show with a drill sergeant guy from the Philippines who's an illegal alien. We already played it earlier. Going, okay, you're white. What do you got to say for that, huh? And even black folks are all over the message boards, I noticed. You write about it. Going, this is crazy racism. Are they going to go too far, Paul? So coordinated, so mechanized, and it's getting weirder by the day. Paul Joseph Watson.
Well, some of those headlines you just read out, Alex, are quite tame in comparison to some of the deep recesses of mental illness that you'll find on places like Tumblr. And I post some of these on my Twitter account. I'll give you an example. An exchange between a boy and a girl on Tumblr. Boy says, I'm only attracted to blonde people. She responds, cool roundabout way of saying you only deem Hitler's chosen people as worthy. So now, only being attracted to blonde women is akin to being
a Nazi. And by the way, all studies show that you're more attracted to people that look like your parents, that they're not sure genetically why black people are attracted to black people, white people to white people. And of course, back and forth, it's just statistically more attracted to, and by the way, black people are attracted to black people who look like their parents, not just black people. Like, big black people are attracted. In fact, they've done genetic tests. They're attracted to folks that are from the same area of Africa versus whites, same area of Europe. I mean, it's just how people work. But again, that's racist, Paul.
Yeah, and you're a Nazi. There's a thing called food kin. You may have heard of other kin. This is people who identify as animals, like people who are now identifying as women. They identify as animals. There's a blog called Little Dumpling, and it's about an individual, this is serious, this is not a parody.
That had their arms and legs cut off?
No, she identifies as a dumpling and is triggered by all cisgendered people, which means all people who are born as the sex they are. So now people are asserting the right to identify as items of food, and if you don't agree with that, if you've got a problem with that, if you laugh at that, you're a racist, because now apparently identifying as food is also a race. This is just examples.
That's why Facebook 2 years ago came out with 50 new sexual orientations to basically flag yourself as.
Yeah. There's a girl who claims that she's in a coma. Telling her that she's not in a coma is ableist.
So what this is this is an introduction of a mental illness virus politically into the young people to where they're going to be just so brain fried and on so many psychotropics and so screwed up that they just have absolutely no hope of ever even being able to tie their shoelaces.
Yeah, but it's now being given legitimacy and channeled into popular culture and the mass media. Of course, it's not as bad as that right now, but that's just a projection of what it could be like in 5-10 years. So basically, this Jose Antonio Vargas has come out. He directed, he presents this new MTV show, basically to make white people very uncomfortable. That was a retweet of a review that he did today.
Yeah, because they deserve it. I mean, what a racist, aggressive statement towards a whole group. But notice, this is always selectively enforced. If Bill Clinton wants to rape women and settle cases, that's fine. If Hillary, you know, wants to sexually harass female employees, it's okay because she's a lesbian. Again, they are selectively allowed to do this, just no one else.
Yeah, and then he claims I mean, I tweeted at him this, which I think is the key point here. You do realize that implying white people are collectively guilty actually emboldens white supremacists and creates more racism. That's the effect it has. When you collectively
But that's why
blame-
the Ford Foundation is directing him, is to put everyone in groups. They couldn't allow the real liberal movement to have equality and freedom and come together. They want divide and conquer. That's what I'm saying, Paul. These are ultra-fascist.
And outright racist. You had Salon.com, remember, after the Boston bombings, they said, quote, Muslims don't need to apologize for the Sarnaevs. I agree, not all Muslims should take collective responsibility for the Boston bombings. But then, after the Dylann Roof shooting in Charleston, they said, quote, white America must answer for the Charleston church massacre. So it's only white people that have to take mass responsibility and be publicly shamed when crazy, unstable white individuals act out violently.
And really, this is just a way to get one group of white people to totally submit and this whole broken coalition strategy and join the trendy Borg, and then the others will scurry off and join the white supremacist right-wing system that's FBI, ADL, Southern Poverty Law Center run. And then that way, everyone just identifies and fights over race all day instead of fighting over lower taxes, more parental rights, more national sovereignty.
Yeah, it's all about making everyone obsessed with identity politics, which is always going to be divisive. And it's going to ensure that we don't come together as a species, as a people, to fight against the true source of tyranny, which is always the state, always the government.
Which is what space aliens would do if they were taking over covertly, which I'm not saying is happening. But the state and the corporate interests that run it are like space aliens. They're diplomatically immune. They're tax exempt. They have armored redoubts. They have countries and sectors, the Vatican, the City of London within London, the District of Columbia, the UN grounds, and other facilities that are above the law and exempt. And they sit there and laugh at all of us while they lead generally traditional lives. Ted Turner, 5 kids. These other globalists, 5, 6 kids. Jets, yeah, and armored cars, huge palaces. They're wearing outfits from 300 years ago, laughing at us. And Club of Rome says they're going to exterminate everybody and return agrarian society for those that they allowed to live with a neo-feudalism while they are in high-tech command bases. I mean, that is literally Zardoz.
And it's all justified via this euphemism, like with the Starbucks thing, which collapsed miserably in complete failure with everyone laughing at it. Oh, we need to have a conversation about race. But they only want to have a conversation about race when it's about blaming white people, inducing white guilt, and publicly shaming white people. You know, if we really want to have a conversation about race, let's draw attention to the fact, as we have, that black people commit over half of homicides despite making up only 13% of the population. Does that mean we blame all black people for the fact that there's a violent element within the black community? No. But are MTV going to make a show called Black People and go and make black people cry on camera and publicly shame them
and
for
say
that.
To them, 53% of homicides are black people. You need to apologize. And they're like, well, I didn't kill anybody. But notice it's MTV. I've talked to a TV executive and a major rock star who were in the meetings in the early 90s, and they said, you better do hip-hop and gangster stuff or you're going to be done. They said, what do you mean? We've been directed by Redstone and government above them to literally create and mainline nothing but gangster rap, and then you see the black crime rate explode. Weaponized media to teach black youths that you're not a man if you don't go shoot some black people, mainly blacks they're killing, and then that's liberal. See what MTV does? And MTV had music awards a few months ago. I saw the clip, Mark Dice did a report where it was black people dancing around with shattered and blown up police cars. I mean, it's so obvious how evil these people are that run MTV.
Yeah, and it's all mega rich white people. That's the point. This is coming from the top down. It's not coming from black people. It's coming from rich white liberals. So again, this is about divide and conquer.
Because they're not liberals. You know, they're not liberals. They're not liberals. I've been around them. I wish this stuff wasn't off record. I could say it. They are the liberal whites are the most. They'll get you aside and start talking about how much they hate black people, and when you don't join their club, they hate you. Look, they know what they're doing. How bad is it going to hurt black people when they get a large portion, a large minority, to start going out and attacking whites 50 times what we've seen so far? How bad is that going to hurt the average black person that just wants to work hard, be successful, and be in society?
It's going to be a complete bloodbath. And as he said, you know, MTV, you go back to the birth of hip-hop music, it was all about becoming empowered, educated, informed, getting out of the hole that they were in. Now it's about, you know, glorified gangbanging, as you said, and it's all being pumped out by Sony, by Viacom, by MTV, by these huge corporations owned by rich white liberals. But, you know, should we feel guilty as white people for the slave trade in America? No. Should black people feel guilty for the fact that the Barbary slave trade, which involved over 1 million white Christian Europeans who were enslaved in North Africa right up until the middle of the 18th century. Arab people were slaves. Chinese people were slaves. Irish people were slaves. That doesn't make the skin color collectively responsible.
I know. It's the overriding and the destruction of history and then just totally invoking all of this.
And then they, you know, he's out there on Twitter, Vargas, this director, saying, oh, this is about empathy. It's not about publicly shaming white people. While tweeting reviews of his show that say it's about making white people feel uncomfortable. Again, the height of hypocrisy.
Well, that's another thing about these so-called liberals, these social engineers, these Lokis, is they're there to stir up stuff, and then they'll talk out of both sides of their mouth. They're so intellectually dishonest because they're talking to an audience. The average viewer of MTV is now about 11. Who thinks they're forming an adult opinion. This man is preying on children. You know, I now think a modern liberal is basically someone that preys on children. I mean, that's it. These people prey on the uninformed. They swim in a sea of ignorance. They want to make everybody poor and dumb. They are pathetic maggots funded by the disgusting Ford Foundation that hatched Adolf Hitler.
It's completely racist. And again, you know, you go back to Ferguson and Baltimore. George Soros funded, once again. This is about divide and conquer.
Stay there. I'm so upset. I skipped a break. Never even plugged this hour. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com. Free shipping the month of July. Buy the books, buy the videos, buy the water filters, or unless you want to drink the fluoride they're putting in there. Everything we sell is incredibly useful, high quality, low price. Free shipping month of July. InfoWarsStore.com or 888-253-3139. Tell friends and family to do it right now. I'm telling you, we're going to destroy the globalists. They're not going to stop us. To do 20 minutes of overdrive today. Some stations carry the fourth hour. But anybody can go to InfoWars.com/show to see it. We're going to premiere, as it's 10 minutes long, an interview that was done this morning by Joe Biggs. Dealing with, I mean, we know it's in the news that the schools do this, the doctors do it, but it actually is happening. He's now interviewing people who you go in Texas with your daughter and your son, and they say, does your mommy let you think you're a boy? Would you like to be a boy? Would your brother like to be a girl? I mean, this is just so invasive. But they're starting forced inoculations in California. And right after that bill passed, now they got two bills to forcibly inoculate adults. The totalitarians are making their move. The stock markets are plunging. This is all unfolding. And Paul Watson, it just never seems to end. I guess do another article tomorrow or today breaking this down. But I mean, you can go dig up the quotes, the universities, because I know we've got them in my film Endgame 1.5, where we had Professor Kaufman on. He brought all these documents, but you can find them online, where they said they would end the family. And the plan was finally an asexual, brave new world. And Huxley gave a speech in 62 before he died. He wrote Brave New World in 32. You wonder how that stuff's coming true. He gave a speech and he admitted, he also wrote Revisiting Brave New World, which is nonfiction, that this is actually the plan. And his brother, of course, ran UNESCO at the UN. So I just don't know if the public can come to grips that this is a scientific takeover. Paul, other points you'd like to add? I mean, if people think this has gotten crazy, it's about to get 10 times crazier because the method is to just make it so bizarre. They take us a trillion miles into Weirdoville. Even if we go back a 500 billion, we're still 500 billion miles down a rat hole. Paul Watson.
Well, again, this director, Jose Antonio Vargas, an illegal immigrant snuck into the country, got an illegal driver's license when he was 16, if I remember correctly. He's all over Twitter now addressing my article, which is on Drudge, not addressing me directly, even though I directly addressed him.
He's a coward.
He's saying, yeah, he's saying white people is not publicly shaming whites. That's not the goal. Goal is to spark constructive conversations.
Yeah, we need the then headline. Right, we need the headline, Paul. Vargas caught in lie. MTV producer caught in huge lie. And then show his tweet saying it's about calling out white people and demonizing white people. And selling racism, which is always popular. Look what they did for the Klan. The Klan failed. They became the Democrats. And that's just a fact. And then just show his tweets. He's a big, fat, disgusting maggot. Sorry, go ahead.
And then you look at all the reviews, because he's saying, oh, you've got to watch it before you make a judgment. All the reviews from people who have watched it, for example, Kristen Yonsu, how she noted how pleased she is about the fact that, quote, lots of white people tears lie ahead. It's always a good time poking fun at white people.
That's right. It's so fun. Again. Oh, what if it's fun? Oh, imagine if a white said in the L.A. Times and the places she's writing, it's always fun to poke fun at blacks. These people are sick. But again, the minorities are now the majority in almost every area. That's the strategy of the Klan that the Democrats became the dominant group of. Is now to just turn minorities into hardcore racist. And I'm not rolling over to it. What about you, Paul?
Well, then they claim that it's impossible for minorities to be racist against white people because of institutionalized racism.
Which is communistic class warfare crap.
Quite a convenient get-out clause, isn't it?
Paul, I'm going to let you go to take on this worm. And I want to challenge this guy to come here to the studio. He likes to bug his eyes out at people and intimidate them all day and act like he's all scary because he's Filipino. So everybody has to bow down to him because he's the new royalty. Why, he's a minority in America. And so you got to bow down to him because you're a racist. He can go straight to hell. Now get after him, Paul. Get after this scumbag. You see, we have to be super radical because the truth is radical. The tactic of the globalists is to be so over the top. And so arrogant in their con game that we just get overwhelmed and go into learned helplessness and get in a fetal position and go into a catatonic state. Globalists can either sell things as being real smooth and sounding reasonable, but that hasn't worked, or they can just be over the top and escalate everything and hit us with everything to where we can't stop every missile they fire at us politically. The only way to counter that is just to be completely over the top, announcing everything they've done and just completely break with them. That's why we've been successful, because we don't mince words in their arrogance. They have intimidated us to have the U.S. military now wear high heels and march in public so that they understand feminism. That means put a male culture down as if you're bad. Well, it's a female culture to be able to have babies. As if differences were bad. Now teaching mainstream news, elementary school students nationwide to be called purple penguins, not boys or girls, because being a boy or a girl could be hurtful to someone that doesn't identify as a boy or a girl. This is a psych warfare strategy to just balkanize everyone into thousands of fighting groups, a Tower of Babel strategy, the broken coalition strategy. And now it's coming out, John Walsh, salon writer. What's the matter with white people finding our way in the next America? And now they have the MTV show about how white people are inherently bad. And they have people writing articles saying it's always good to see whites cry and to poke fun at them. See, the new sport. See, I find it offensive to see black people being made fun of if it's being done because they're black. If you're making fun of funny black people because they're funny people, like Red Fox, then it's funny. Like Rodney Dangerfield's a funny white guy. It's funny. It's not making fun of whites. It's making fun of that type of white guy. Like Red Fox. I was just watching him the other morning. It's funny because he's like a real old guy. It's like Archie Bunker. But see, now only Hollywood is allowed to be politically correct. No one else can. And they expand the political correctness to where no communication is okay. Where there's secret racism hidden everywhere. the truth is the United States doesn't have that much resources compared, except for oil, compared to places like Mexico or the continent of Africa. But we had more free market, more honoring of private property, and we had real Christian values. Not that they were ever fully realized, but compared to other nations, they were. It was Christianity that moved worldwide in the last 600 years to ban slavery. And it took 400 plus years to get it done, except for in Arab countries and African countries and some Asian. But it's okay when they do it. It's like, oh, you're a bond servant. You know, in Tibet, in the caste, the lowest levels like slaves, and in India, with liberals, it's like, but that's their culture, that they're slaves. They're the untouchable ones. It's so liberal. Oh, they smoke hookahs, the Taliban, or the ISIS, and then they mutilate the women and put bags on their head, but you're being racist against their culture. It's a culture. What's bad in America is that is white men. I mean, it is just crazy. So I wanted to ask Larry Nichols, the consummate Clinton insider, ran the campaigns for them for governor. They got into huge corruption. He couldn't be part of it. Went public, the Clinton Chronicles, you name it. Bill Clinton was just recently quoted, what was it, the New York Times, about what do you worry about in Hillary's campaign? Larry Nichols, Larry Nichols, Larry Nichols. I mean, if you don't know who Larry Nichols is, it's because you weren't paying attention to Clinton politics when we had the nightmare 8 years of those people. Jeb Bush, I believe, is a ringer. As much as I like Donald Trump's rhetoric, I've seen him do this before, and I know a lot of insiders that say he's a ringer. He's a ringer for Jeb to get more attention from other Republican candidates like Rand Paul. And even if he doesn't know it, I think Trump knows it. They got too much dirt on him. And then the ultimate ringer is Jeb Bush. Hillary is it. Bilderberg, our only hope is to torpedo her with enough scandals. She just came out yesterday and said she's never been subpoenaed. She's been subpoenaed more than five times. I was able to Google Hillary subpoenaed. In fact, I'm going to do a piece on that today. And you can just show all the articles. And her own lawyers went, that's actually not true. I mean, the level of lying, but this is targeting people. 8 out of 10 in California we've talked to in a poll, our reporter, Mark Dice, didn't know what Independence Day was. There it is. CNN even had to admit she's lying. Clinton subpoena claim undercut by lawyer's reply. Now, he's going to drop bizarro bombshells on you, but you need to know this. And I meant to call one of the authors I knew that wrote the book, Big Sis. It's a place I've seen. It was in a California paper that said that, you know, she monthly would fly there to have a shamanistic ritual done. But we looked it up. It's not a shamanistic ritual. It was a cultic European-style druidic ritual. You can pull it up. Tony Blair's wife is a witch. In fact, I meant to tell you guys who that so you'd have more time, but just tie in that. Just start searching and we'll probably find it. But he dropped the bombshell at the end of the last interview saying, listen, you don't know how weird she is. And he has it from his sources. She's actually a devil worshiper, basically. Well, of course she is. Who sits around going, I came to Libya, I saw he's dead, and I was almost shot down in Serbia when it wasn't true, and just all the evil and all the dead bodies around her, and grabbing on all the women and, you know, dragging them off into her office, and witchcraft, nail and clippings, the weird world of Sherry Blair. Yeah, you found the Independent. Google Tony Blair, the spirit of the light, and he flops on the ground and foams, and it possesses him each day and then tells him what to do. That's been like, but the BBC is like, it's so wonderful. He's possessed and he flops around. Maybe he shoots green pea soup out. He goes and gets in underground culverts at Aztec temples and does secret rituals. It's so beautiful. It's so liberal. Francois Mitterrand had the Louvre Pink Pyramid built. It has 666 pieces and is dedicated to Lucifer. Google that. That's mainstream news. But the Hillary ones I know I found, he has that. But the bigger bombshell is the chef, the dead chef. Why was the chef killed? That ties into Obama. And then when we expand out, we're going to look at who is Chelsea's real dad. Because, you know, if we're going to risk our lives, why not just sign John Hancock down at the bottom, gigantic? People think he was the first to sign. No, he wasn't. He signed the biggest because it was a death warrant for many. Robert Harris, Tony Blair's weirder than almost anyone. And what publication is that? That's the Express. Okay, does that have him flopping on the ground, possessed by the spirit of the light? We'll find it. But just be aware that when we make these claims, truth stranger than fiction, these people are insane. I mean, look at Bohemian Grove I snuck into that Richard Nixon said was the most GD faggy thing he'd ever seen. And it's a bonding experience, and I'm not attacking gay people. The point is, though, this is how they compromise the Republican leaders. You don't get into the leadership unless you go to the Grove and you know what you do. A lot of gangs say you got to go rob a liquor store. You got to shoot an old lady. You got to shoot at a cop, or you got to, you know, rob a whatever. Well, for the Republican leadership, you go to Bohemian Grove, you get naked, you party, you use drugs, you drink alcohol, and you have sex with gay porn stars. Okay, let's go ahead. And, you know, you can have women, too. They're just outside at the hotel down the street and the golf course. You want to know where to pick up top hookers in the world? Female ones, I'm told. You just go for the 2 weeks Bohemian Grove to the golf course nearby and the bar in there, and it'll just be lined up, you know, better than a Monte Carlo brothel, ladies and gentlemen. So, you know, the Republicans, most of them really don't want to do it. But, you know, John Ronson stuck in with me. He and we're just, I apologize to Nichols. I'm going to him. He didn't want to get in trouble with the TV production he was doing for World of Wonder and Channel 4 in England, so he snuck in with me and Mike Hansen, then pledged me to never say it. Then he went on Coast to Coast AM and said, yeah, I snuck in with Alex Jones. People said, why didn't you say? Because I have a journalistic thing. If it's off record, it's off record. And he's my witness. The camera only took hour-long tapes then. The Secret Service was following us. I couldn't get video. He saw it. A photo. Get Ronson back on as soon as you can. A photo of Henry Kissinger bent over in drag. And that's whatever. Maybe he was in a play. Sticking his fingers in his hind end. Okay? Let's just let it all out. Let's just attack on every front with the truth. Maximum push. And I apologize to the family audience, but you have a right to know what's going on. And Richard Nixon probably went in there and, you know, he didn't like it. But you know what? He did it. Skull and bones, same deal. You wallow in feces and have orgies in huge vats of feces, and that's even in the movie The Good Shepherd, produced by Robert De Niro. I'm skipping the network break, but no more this week, Harmon. I'm not allowed to skip breaks tomorrow, and I apologize. I'm even skipping plugs. I'm just telling everything. I can't stand it anymore. John Ronson saw it with me. It was horrific. Okay, I mean, it's disgusting. I can't get it out of my mind. It is. Larry Nichols, I'm really asking for it, brother. How you doing?
I tell you what, Alex, that little intro there, you just described things I don't even want to see in my mind. Kissinger with his finger up his butt? No.
I'm sorry. I apologize, right. But it's true. Go ahead.
Well, my friend, thank you for having me on. I promised you last time that I was here that I would break you a news story. And so I'm proud to say that you're the first. It will come out July the 15th in the National Enquirer. Remember, I had gone in the Enquirer some weeks back and said Chelsea was not Bill's kid.
And don't forget, they hit them with anthrax last time, so I wonder if that'll happen again.
Yeah, well, I'm getting ready. But if you will go to the July 15th National Enquirer article, you will see that DNA is in, the DNA results are in, and Chelsea is not Bill Clinton's daughter. She's Hubble's.
And you've always said that, and she's as horrible, she's as ugly as him, and I don't mean to be mean, but she does look like a toad.
You know, Alex, it's hard to fight the Clintons, and I know there are people in your audience saying, oh, how tacky of a thing to do. Let me tell you something, folks. Chelsea is a part of the Clinton cabal. She's right in the middle of it. Clinton Foundation. All of them are together.
Oh, yeah. We're going to be, she'll be running for president, too. So, I mean, she's like one of the spawn of Medusa. We've got to expose her.
But, Alex, it's important, folks, and I beg you all to listen to me. I'm one man. I'm just one. And as Alex can tell you, the deck is stacked. They've got their people throughout, a part of the system that they have. As you know, Alex, they control justice, they control Congress, they control the media. And folks, if we're going to save our country, we're going to have to find a place to go. And Alex, I'm so honored. I've talked to some 1,100 of your followers after our last program. They've literally called, and I've actually talked to them. And I am impressed. I was shocked, to be honest, Alex. I was concerned. You know, I thought when you take the 20-somethings, 30-somethings, 40-somethings, and even 50-some-odd-year-old people, they wouldn't remember the Clintons, and they'd have no interest in all of this. And my word, Alex, there's a young man, a black man in Chicago called me, and he's forming up a group. He's very excited. He listens to you all the time. There's people in Georgia, the 20-something crew in Georgia. You know, Alex, I hate to dump it on you. It's not going to, you probably need to buy an insurance policy. But you may indeed end up being the last bastion of hope we have of getting the truth out, even when the truth hurts.
Well, Larry, you're nice to say that. And I kind of get wound up doing this dangerous job and get a little arrogant about the Kissinger thing. And, I mean nothing against Chelsea Clinton. I don't like messing with people's kids. Plus, it's dangerous. But she is a political front, kind of like the White House.
That's
will
right.
have a mascot, a dog or a cat that makes them look more human. They've used Chelsea. I don't know enough of her being evil to actually attack her. So I apologize for calling her toad-like. But she does look like Webster Hubble's daughter. So let's talk more about that. And then let's get into... you're risking your life yet again. You're the big Clinton insider. We appreciate you coming on. Break down why this is important about the Hubble situation, and then let's get into the cook. Let's get into the witchcraft.
Now you're just trying to get me killed, aren't you? I thought you were my friend.
Let's just go all the way. Let's do it.
I know. Well, let me say this. The reason the Chelsea information is important is because, folks, it's all a lie. It is all a lie. When I came out years ago and said, you know, Chelsea wasn't Bill's kid, that it was Hubble's, I took it on the chin from every which way. But we have to tell the truth of these people. These people are fixing, Alex, to take over and run this country. This election, by the way, folks, is fait accompli. They know what they're doing. Hillary's running it exactly like my playbook says run. And believe me, it's deadly. It's accurate. And so what's going to happen is Jeb Bush, for anybody that doesn't know, when you sit down and look under our system, who, one of the things with the Clinton, you always control your opposition. That's key. That is key to any race. So when Hillary's sitting there and her brainiacs, and they're going, well, now what's the only thing out there that could hurt Hillary? Well, it's the fact that the Clinton dynasty image is out there. The name, she's been around forever. So you see, Alex, there's only one person that trumps that. Who's been around in politics more than the Clintons? The Bushes. So Jeb Bush takes that argument off the table. She's there.
That's right. They neutralize each other because the only two choices you have are the two new political royal dynasties that are now running head-to-head, and they give you a fake choice of two dynasties. Yeah. We need an election, not a coronation.
Well, we're going to, with your permission, as we go through this, there is a way to whip this and to beat them. I should know, because I helped build a system that's got them here and keeping them here. And all we can do is just pray, Alex, that I do still have a little bit of knowledge of what to do. But now, I heard you talking, and I know people are going to go, what is this about witchcraft? Once again, years ago, I was there, folks. You understand there's a difference in somebody that saw it or read it somewhere. I was there. Hillary would go on the weekend, about every fourth, fifth weekend, she would disappear out to California. Finally, she came back and said, Hillary, what on earth is happening in California? She was running with her actress buddies, Linda Bloodworth Thomason and that crew. And she never told me. Finally, Bill told me that she goes out there to some kind of witch's church. And I said, you've got to be kidding me, Bill. No. He said, oh, no, man, she does. But you got to understand, Bill and Hillary have an open relationship. They don't care. They don't care. Back then, you would have called them swingers. She did who she wants to. He did who she wants to, as long as the two just wasn't each other. And then for all those people that say, well, what's that got to do with anything? Hey, let me tell you something, folks. Our nation is going to be under judgment by God. Now, we've already opened up the door with the homosexual junk, right? How many churches, Alex, this weekend when it comes time to preach, how many preachers are going to be able to preach the part about the Bible that refers to sodomy? They got to be careful if they do, because there'll be hate speech. And then you run into, well, if they can't talk about sodomy, then what else, Alex, are we having removed from us culturally? I mean, I don't know.
Well, they're now banning the Ten Commandments everywhere and pulling it out. They're now telling Christians in Oregon you cannot preach your faith because it's hurtful. They're now getting rid of the free speech by fiat. I mean, this is serious.
It is. And that's, you know, people, God, dog it, Pete, you know, Alex.
Is that why the totalitarian left is so arrogant now? Because they know they've got it all fixed, all lined up, and the real reign of terror is about to begin?
They've got it. They know it. And they know that everything we need to do, just so everybody knows, let's just lay it on the table. Let's lay it there, Alex. Number one, who in the hell are you going to call? I remember being in the cloakroom, David Shippers and I, when Bob Dole, Trent Locke came in and said, no matter what Clinton wants, this is during his trial for his impeachment. We already got him impeached. This is the Senate trial. And I said, you're crazy as hell. Shippers said, ain't no way. They said, look, you can read it in his own book. I don't care if you've got him shooting a woman in the face from downtown in front of everybody on tape. He's walking. Well, we come into that trial. First thing that happens when it comes to the vote, we had him. We had him. Except one person. One person. Arlen Specter of Pennsylvania, I believe. Arlen Specter comes in and he abstains. He abstained. He didn't vote. When that happened, that threw the vote into a tie, which meant then Al Gore got to cast his vote. And when he cast his vote innocent, Bill Clinton walked. 3 weeks later, maybe 4 weeks later, Arlen Specter's wife gets an appointment by the Clinton administration to the Parks and Tourism Commission of the United States of America for $250,000 a year. Bill Clinton walked. Now, they control justice. Justice. Now, ask Trey Gowdy. Ask all of those people, if you will. And say, well, she obviously destroyed those emails. They can't do anything about it because you know what? They got to go to the Justice Department to get the Justice Department to prosecute. And since they picked the justice, they ain't going to get prosecuted. Then we're all sitting around wondering, what in the hell? And you say, well, then they're just bulletproof. No, they're not bulletproof. It's just the system that controls our
That's right. They've taken
today.
Over. That's why. And now they want to mop things up and really sew the country up. Stay with us. People either fight or they flight. And when I see all this craziness going on, I just get arrogant. I get aggressive in the face of it because... quite frankly, it's either that or sell everything I got and flee the country. And my family on both sides has been in Texas since the late 1820s. I love America. America is the best of times, worst of times. But we really are being taken down by a new type of warfare. And I wanted to ask Larry Nichols, I went to that whole 10-minute rant before he came on, as he was on hold, about the cultural degradation and the really targeting kids with pedophilia. That's what this whole agenda is in the schools, sexualizing them, saying that we can teach your kids, you know, that they're a different sex. I mean, it's just crazy. And then I wonder what comes next. I remember Jocelyn Elders, their Supreme Court nominee. We ought to get those famous clips of her. I haven't aired those in like 18 years. And her creepy voice going in a weird, you know, general outfit. We need to teach the children to masturbate. We need to reach down and help them. I mean, it's like, it's a freak show. A freaky woman want to talk about our children? I mean, it's like, what is it your place, you crazy woman? All of you people. And it's just the fact that they are disturbed. I mean, I never get sick of enchiladas and cold beer. I never get sick of, just basic things I like. I don't get always wanting to get weirder and weirder and weirder and weirder. And then I'm a tolerant person, so I'm not after people that are into weird stuff as long as you don't hurt somebody else. but then you want to conquer me. It's an act of rape, basically. And it's, I mean, I go out to these abortion clinics and I told people these stories for years, and we finally caught it on tape. We brought cameras. People just appear in black. They were black, they were white, they were Hispanic. Evil doesn't have a color. And they just showed up and they were like, we want to kill babies. We kill babies. We love Satan. We stink. We love death. Ah, Satan. And then at the Capitol, they had Christians down there praying 2 years ago, made national news, and spontaneously women in business suits and clean cut just went, Satan, 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 Satan. I mean, it's like something out of a horror movie. They're so loud. When you listen to the audio, it kind of distorts on AM radio, but anybody can type in women chant Hell Satan in Texas Capitol, and they got their tongues out like snakes, and they're just, they're possessed by something. Something's going on here. Briefly, because I've skipped so many breaks and everything else, support the GCN Radio Network, GCNlive.com, support InfoWarsHealth.com, where you can get over 400 amazing longevity products that are just some of the best out there, the Beyond Tangy Tangerine, the Pollen Burst. People, you know, it's got pollen and a bunch of other key vitamins that just give people an incredible healthy energy boost. I endorse it, Pollen Burst. There are just the Alex Pack that's discounted with the Osteo FX and other key things together. InfoWarsHealth.com. If you sign up there for $10, you can get 30% off your first order, so it's well worth it. And then if you sign up for auto ship, you get free shipping. InfoWarsHealth.com or InfoWarsTeam.com if you want to be a distributor. And it's also a great business opportunity. At the same time, I have my own supplement line. It's not as massive because it's taken us time to develop each one. We haven't been around 18 years like they have. And if you go to InfoWarsTeam.com, you can basically sign up. Takes about a minute to do, and then get even bigger discounts. There's a bunch of audio, video information there. But InfoWarsLife.com is my line of supplements. We've got, 14 different ones now. 7 of them are sold out. Half of them are sold out. We're getting better about our supply chain. But we are selling out a Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine X2, that fills up your different glands with the good halogen, not the bad one, fluoride and chlorine and bromide and bromine and the rest of it. That's about to sell out. We're sold out of Brain Force and a lot of other great products. We are going to sell out of the Oxy Powder group supplies that he's selling out. Incredible intestinal flush, like nothing you've ever done. And your purchases make this whole transmission possible. So you're not just getting great products at very affordable prices. Free shipping in the month of July on all the InfoWars Life products. Free shipping on all the shortwave radios, books, videos, Second Amendment t-shirts, high-quality non-GMO heirloom seeds. It's got to be over 500 items now for sale at InfoWarsStore.com. It's the blanket site. You can find InfoWarsHealth.com there, InfoWarsLife.com there. You can find Maiden1776.com there. 25% off on the Molon Labe belt buckles. We had 5 limited edition designs, only 200 to 500 of each design, depending on which design. 3 have now sold out. There are, 2 designs left. At InfoWarsStore.com or 888-253-3139. And they hate the fact we're here. White House-run platforms like Media Matters attack us every week, every day almost. They got the Washington Post, Hardball, Slimeball, other shows this week saying I'm racist because I'm concerned about the Jade Helm drills. This is their new move. So we need your prayers more than anything, spreading the word secondarily. Don't take for granted. I mean, I took my daughter, because 2 of my children are at camp, Christian camp. I took my youngest daughter for a hike yesterday and to swim in Barton Creek while it's full. Austin's just lush right now. And it wasn't that busy on a Wednesday. And there was probably 30 people at the particular falls I went to. On the weekend, it might be 100. There's a whole chain of, you know, great swimming holes there in the creek. And everyone was staring at me. Basically, everyone, old, young, black, white. I probably had, out of 30 people, 10 come over and shake my hand. And I was out in a rock while she snorkeled, looking at fish out in the middle by the waterfalls. And they would swim over. And they were all so cool and so nice. But even in Austin, where obviously I have more listeners anywhere else, almost everyone was a listener. And then I've been live video at Big Bend out on the bridge, and every third person walks by as a listener. More like every other person. I mean, I'm not bragging. The show really is big. It's an anomaly. It's the blessing of God. I'm teleprompter free. I'm very obnoxious because it's real. You try talking for 3 hours and risking your life. And I don't say that lightly. This, I'm surprised I'm still alive, but it's the grace of God, the fact that we're so vocal. So support us, InfoWarsStore.com. And listen, Larry Nichols is a sweetheart and lost everything he had with his very successful businesses when he went up against the Clintons. And he doesn't ask for this. He didn't even get money from what I was told by the producers at Jeremiah Films for being the key guy. And they actually killed some people that were in the movie, the Clinton Chronicles and one other one. He lost everything he had. He doesn't ask for this. Instead of calling him because he just wants to organize people, he talked so much he couldn't come on Monday because his voice was gone. You don't need to just call him. You need to just write him with a donation, whether it's $5 or $100, so that he can live modestly where he lives. I know folks that have been to his house to interview him. Very modest there with his dachshund. Been shot at, been attacked. State police have been attacked. People have been killed that he's interviewed. He needs your support. Larry Nichols, 58 Kingston Drive, Conway, Arkansas, 72034. And Ivor Kingsington, I can't seem to talk today. Larry Nichols, 58 Kingsington Drive, Conway, Arkansas, 72034. And that's spelled K-E-N-S-I-N-G-T-O-N. Kensington Drive. So Larry Nichols, 58 Kensington Drive, Conway, Arkansas, 72034. Or give him a call, 440-897-0611, or NicholsLive@AOL.com. But that said, I expect if they've ever run me to ground and shut down InfoWars, which believe me, they're trying like a pack of devils to do, we just don't give it attention. Because every time we get attacked, we just get blessed. And I didn't used to be this much of a preacher. You get in a foxhole, folks. God takes you through so many bad things. You just get a closer and closer relationship, plus the discernment you get, the good people that come to your aid. I just expect if anybody ever runs me to ground, that folks are going to help me out as well. Because people always say, where are the good people? Where are the whistleblowers? We had the deputy head of emergency management in New York City on this show to say there were bombs in Building 7, and they told him get out, they were going to blow it up, and 2 weeks later, he was dead. Okay? I mean, the D.C. madam, dead. I can't tell you how many people we've interviewed who they kill, but it's because they didn't stay public enough, and they had dirt they didn't drop. So, Larry, I'm ranting here, but I want you to speak to the evil, the state taking over our kids, MSNBC and promos saying your kids belong to us. I mean, there's a method of their madness, but aren't these also just psycho control freaks that have collected an army of scum? I mean, I have never seen such evil. And then the Republican leadership is there aiding and abetting them. And then it just came out yesterday, Judicial Watch, that indeed the memos, they were ordered in 2008 to target Christians, conservatives, veterans groups, and put them in jail, which they've been doing. I mean, they've now indicted the Texas Attorney General that fought to keep our power plants on and fought Obamacare and fought gay marriage. And they indicted him over a $1,000 filing fee he forgot to do once he stopped doing stock trading. He just let his license lapse and then still sold some stock. And then Hillary's taking money from third world dictators directly to her foundation and then taking arms import bans off, export bans off. I mean, it is just crazy how nakedly criminal they are. Who are these people?
Alex, number one, what you've been describing is part of what we did in 86. It's called social engineering. Through social engineering, you get the public to adapt. And by that, I mean, if all you hear is what ABC, NBC, the news networks, all of that, if that's all you hear and that's what you digest as the truth, then you've lost. And I don't care about people that lose, Alex. I care about us, the people that are sitting out here. Good God, y'all, if you love your children, if you love your grandchildren, if you love your dog, whatever, there's got to be something you love so much that as you see what's going on, you stand up and say, that's it, enough.
Where is your line in the sand? What are you going to put up with? Because and you said the key here. I know you're a lot smarter than I am, and you're a big insider. I was on a plane. I've told the story 50 times, but I don't know if you ever heard me say it. Flying to be on The View, first class, American Airlines, and the head of one of the big six banks is on the plane. And he figures out who I am, and he looks at me, and he goes, you think people are going to adapt and overcome our system? He goes, they're going to evolve and adapt to submit to it, and laughed at me. And you just said that. You guys were social engineering to make people adapt to submit to the tyranny. Explain that.
Well, what happens, where we got it actually is from Mein Kampf. It's all about what people hear over and over and over again. If that's all you hear, then it becomes so. And they take over the schools. They take, well, that's why all of this stuff with that, whatever it is, the school thing, Common Core, all of that is a systematic way to go after the youth, get the youth through the peer pressure organization. You get them to understand and believe what you want. And then it happens. It's magic. It just keeps growing, and it just keeps growing. Then you divide and conquer. Then you go out and you look at all the different segments. You look at the blacks. You look at the Mexicans. You look at the homosexuals. You look at the hippies. And you get them all identified as groups, and you empower them. And what you're actually doing, Alex, is you're stripping down the moral Christian conservatives in this country. And guys, I'm not lying to you. We got one more election if we get it. And then our days of ever having the ability to change the law or get things made right will be gone. Think about it, Alex.
And they've told us they're going to march in and take our kids from us.
That's right. Now, listen, I'm on an all declaration being honest. You know my situation, and thank you for talking about it, folks. I've got to have $5,000 for some health issues, and I mean fast. Where's it going to come from? Nowhere. Nowhere. By the way, thanks to your people, I did set up a PayPal account. I don't know how it works, but that's nicholslive@AOL.com. But think about what I go through every day. Do y'all not think I'm ashamed? Do y'all not think it hurts me to the core? But if I don't do it, nobody's going to do it. And if I get quiet, you'll be reading about me dead somewhere. You will. And I, at this point, death would be a blessing. So if anybody...
Well, I know your dad died of lung cancer, and you hinted at that. How is your health right now?
Bad. You hear it? So all I ask, if there's anybody out there, dear God in heaven, right now, it's that emergency. Call me when this program's over if you can help. But now listen, don't let that deter what I say. I have never been on the air raising money because I don't want that to deter.
Yeah, no, you didn't do it 20 years ago or 10 years ago with me, but I know you're real sick right now. And, you know, just thank God that you've lived this long to keep exposing the Clintons. And you know, I want to send a crew up to actually interview you. So we get it all on record and you know, really expose the real Clintons, because I don't want to just have half measures here. We need a new Clinton Chronicles. We need Jeremiah Films, if they're still around, or somebody to really expose these monsters.
Alex, what's going to have to happen, and I hate to say it, but folks, there's got to be an education campaign. We've got to re-educate people. Hell, I don't even know anymore if we have genes in our bodies that are connected to our founding fathers. We've drifted so far away. But here's what's going to come. You got two choices right now. Two. Believe it or not, our best friends on earth right now are Bill and Hillary. Why? Because Obama has his eyes set on turning us into an Islamic caliphate. And at that point, he would become the leader of Islam globally. Now, the only people strong enough at this point to stop that from happening are the Clintons. And then if the Clintons get in, then we're fighting communism. But I think we stand a better chance trying to fight communism than people running around with their heads being cut off, because people will go into submission instantly.
You know, I used to hear this about Obama being a closet radical Muslim, and I didn't believe it, but then his half-brothers and cousins are involved funding it in Egypt, and he overthrows all our allies and puts ISIS in control and then won't let us. I mean, this is crazy.
It is. Now, I want you to think about something, guys, all of you. Think about it. Obama has what he wants. Hillary has what she wants. The problem we have is we've got the best government money can buy. It's just we, the people, don't have the money to buy it anymore. They're not even bothering to lie to us anymore. Now they just say stuff. They know it comes out untrue. They don't care because they know they have got us down. We are so close, Alex.
I know. I can feel it. Stay there. Final segment straight ahead. Larry Nichols. By the way, I have a really bad tendency to get up here and start telling stories and then not finish them and then go into another one. I was telling the story about how many listeners there were at the hike and bike trail yesterday. And it was just shocking that it was like almost everybody was like waving at me and people were coming up. A third of the people at least came up. That paradox, like it, basically 90% of people are listeners in one spot. But I get it. They're out there in nature not watching TV. I go to UT and almost everybody doesn't even know what the Declaration of Independence Day is. They don't even know what the July 4th is. So my point is, those of you that are awake are more important than I am or Larry Nichols, and that's what he keeps getting at. We have to say no to this. We have to point out this is psychological warfare. This is social engineering. We're with the guy on record who was the main handler for the Clintons in their first couple of gubernatorial runs, because it was a bi-gubernatorial. This is the guy, the Clinton chronicles everything. And they killed hundreds of people in Arkansas alone, chopped their arms, legs off, throw them in a dump. They'd rule it a suicide, kill kids that saw the drug flights coming in. And I haven't just interviewed him. I've interviewed CIA officers like Terry Reid, who we can't get a hold of, who used to see it going on with the Clintons. And he said, I'm not doing this. Cocaine? Same thing Larry Nichols said, you know, just going too far. Tosh Plumlee, famous CIA whistleblowers, come on. He's on, when is Plumlee on, tomorrow? He's on next Tuesday. So there are good people. It doesn't mean they're perfect, but when it rubber meets the road, they are not truly evil, and they'll say no. And that's the good news I think Larry Nichols has been getting at. Things are going to get so bad either way now. We're going under judgment that you will be forced to finally say no. But Churchill said there are times in history when you can easily win a fight against a tyrant, but you don't do it. Then there comes a time where it's going to be a hard fight and you still don't do it. But then there comes a time where there's no way you're going to win, but you've already seen such atrocities and such evil done that it's better to down your feet than a slave. Folks, let's not go down that road. I innately at a cellular level have to stand up against these people. Believe me, I don't like doing it, but it's got to be done. Larry Nichols, we're going to hold you 5 minutes in the next hour. Then we got a special report of them when you take your kid into the doctor, they push you out of the room and say, how does your child sexually identify? And then try to teach your kid that they can be a woman if they're a boy or a man if they're a girl. I mean, it's just Twilight Zone, how they're training us to do whatever they want. But we got 2 minutes to break. How do we stop the Clintons? I mean, I guess just bring out all their scandals?
Yeah, Alex, I'll be on here every week. And every week I'm on here, I will bring out another scandal. And I'm not talking about BS. I'm talking about things that I can prove in a court of law, and they know I can. And then you just educate, and you get people to have courage. Good God, courage. That's what we're lacking today, courage. And if you'll stand up, if you will stand up, they can't hurt you. They can't. But if you bow down, this is a game, Alex, of submission. And if you had never learned that word, you better learn it. Submission is when you give up. Now, I'm having the day to beg for money like some creepy old guy on the side of a curve just because of the urgency of the problem. And I hate that with a passion. But I swear to God, Alex, in the next few weeks, people are going to know the whole truth. And I'm going to provide you with evidence and documents that people in Congress didn't want to touch. You know why? They said, well, hell, that'll get us hurt. Oh, yeah. Well, great. Now what are you going to do?
Well, and you're also, don't just provide me with it. I'm glad you're giving it to the Inquirer and others because I don't like to dole out this info. I'm not afraid to die, but I'm not jumping in front of any trains, if you know what I mean. But I tell you, this is some powerful information. Stay there. We're going to come back, and let's just get more into the basics of it so that we're covered, and then we can get it specifically in the weeks to come. Because it's like I told the D.C. madam, don't try to tell me anything off air. She was. The thing about tyrants is they don't just want to take over. They want to run your life, and they want to pull down good things and build up bad things. They're demons. And for anybody that studied history, you know that's true. The problem is, Larry Nichols, former top Clinton insider, what do you do? I don't know if you've seen these Mark Dice videos that we posted at Infowars.com and that DrudgeReport.com picks up. Well, let me go out and do similar ones. Where 8 out of 10 people don't even know what Independence Day is. Or you go and talk to liberals and you go, we want to put gun owners in forced labor camps and we want to kill them. And they'll sign the petition to kill. I mean, these aren't liberals. You're right. They put them in a group. MSNBC tells them they're empowered. And so now it's like they're an officer or something in the military and they have esprit de corps. And all they know is they hate anything called libertarian or conservative or free. And because you say, we want to put them in a forced labor camp for Obama. We want to put them in a camp and kill them for Obama. And they all sign, basically, not 8 out of 10, 9 out of 10. What do you call people like that? I mean, don't they know they're not going to get free goodies forever and they're just cannon fodder?
No, that's the problem, Alex. So many people are getting hooked on the pit of getting something from the government. Until now, we're at that crossover point. And guys, when they make all the illegal Mexicans be able to vote, that'll be the last election we have. But there is a way to stop it, Alex. You can do it. I can't, but you can't. But it's going to take taking your audience. I got to do it. We got to take your audience to the next level. And I've got to show you the things that they're going to do, and I'll do it before they do it so that you'll be able to tell your friends and neighbors, hey, this nutbag said this, and then watch it happen. They're going to lie. Everything they say is a lie. Everything you see on TV is a lie. It's crafted. It's well orchestrated. But this system's so big now, Alex, that they control it all unless it's you. And a few programs like yours. So I just want to say this before you and I hang up, I got to tell you something in confidence, not going to get you killed, but I do have to tell you. And then all I can say is this lady, a kind lady with listenupaudiobooks.com, she's trying to get my book, The Genie, and make it. So if you want to get in touch with them, you can go to that site and they're going to give you something off. But you know, Alex,
absolutely. You need to find yourself. So it's great you're trying to do that. Specifically, what are some of the other
today?
What are some of the other big bombshells you're going to be dropping soon?
Next week, you're going to have the actual Secret Service memo. You're going to have it about Vince Foster. And it's where the Park Police notified the White House Secret Service. This is the official document. And in it, they tell Scott Carpenter, Secret Service official in charge of the White House that night, that they found the body of Vince Foster in his car in the Fort Marcy parking lot. 38 caliber revolver was in the car with him, along with a 6-pack of Bartle and James. One had already been opened, and a briefcase in the back. They had nothing in it. Now, that briefcase, by the way, is the same one 3 days later. They ransacked Foster's office, found it again, dumped it upside down, nothing. 2 days later, they find it again, except this time, there was the suicide note. Now, this is the highest-ranking official since Kennedy to die in office.
Why did they kill him? Because he broke up with Hillary?
Alex, I can't say, and I've said it a million times, and I'm saying it loud and clear here. I don't know if they killed him or somebody killed him or if he killed himself. But here's what I can prove beyond any shadow of any doubt. And, folks, I'm the guy that worked with the Star Investigation. They moved that body. Now, they moved it to get it out of the jurisdiction of the D.C. police over into the park so it would be under the park police, which, as you know, has always been a fixer for the government. But now, guys, Alex is going to have that document.
That's why they keep finding dead pages in the parks, because they haul them there after they've killed them in their offices. We're going to talk again next week or the week after about Vince Foster specifically with Larry Nichols. Larry, thank you so much. Special report coming up. We've only got 1 minute, basically, till we go to this powerful Joe Biggs interview with how they're taking the kids away from the parents when you go to the doctor and asking them, you know, what their sexual orientation is, trying to confuse them and jack with them. And that's in the news. I mean, they admit it's going on, but just to actually hear about it happening, even in Texas, is incredible. Larry Nichols just dropped a bombshell on me where he's going to vet and get more intel on it. But everybody knows the Clinton chef, executive chef, was found dead a few weeks ago, former White House chef. And let's just say Nichols has been contacted about it and is investigating it right now. It's very dangerous information. So, Larry, thank you so much. We'll work on this, work more on that story. And then we will get that information out. It's not fun to mess with this type of stuff, but it's what we're here to do. Somebody's got to not be a coward, and you certainly are it, buddy. So God bless you, and get well, because he is very ill. He doesn't want me to talk about it on air. But Larry needs your support as well. And so thank you so much, Mr. Nichols. We'll talk to you soon.
Alex, tell him PayPal, NicholsLive@AOL.com. Please.
Absolutely. I understand for that medical care that's urgent. Thank you so much, Larry Nichols. Here is the report from Joe Biggs detailing exactly the type of culture that we're talking about and that we're dealing with. And this is just the beginning. They can get away with this. They can get away with anything. Here is the special report. It'll be posted at InfoWars.com.
Joe Biggs here with InfoWars.com. Now, just moments ago, I had the opportunity to speak with a very concerned mother, Jessica Bianchi. Now, she took her two children, a boy and a girl, the girl's about 8 years old, to the doctor for a normal routine visit. And some of the questions that were asked of her children were quite concerning. Now, just so a lot of you don't think that I'm pulling your leg, I want to give you a couple references of things that have happened that have been in mainstream news about transgender roles with children, things like that, the way that our current society is kind of pushing that on these young children. Now, this is an article from Washington Times. Children's Hospital opens clinic for transgender children. This is out of Dallas AP. And then also we have out of CBN News, gender identity curriculum angers parents in Virginia. So this is something that is happening in and around our country as we speak right now. And also we have a Bloomberg article, California lets grade schoolers decide gender identity. What kind of kid is able to make a decision like that at such a young age? Their minds are still being molded at this point in time. From National Review, school told to call kids purple penguins because boys and girls is not inclusive to transgender. These are dark times that we are living in now. The fact that this is the kind of stuff that is being pushed on our children. Now we're going to go to my interview with Jessica Bianchi and let her tell her side of the story. All right, thanks. Now we're going to interview Jessica Bianchi. Now, she is a mother who just recently took her kids to the doctor. Now, Jessica, tell us what happened the other day.
Well, I was taking my two kids in. I have a son, Nathan, who is 6, and a daughter, Kayla, who's just about to be 8. And this was just kind of a routine annual checkup. Called ahead to make sure there was no shots, so it was pretty, wasn't going to be any surprises or anything like that. And we got there, and you know, they started doing the routine things and asking some questions like, you know, are your kids getting fruits and vegetables every day? And then they started asking some more kind of alarming questions, one of which was, are your children being properly socialized? Which, of course, sent a huge red flag in my mind. We had a family just one county over from us who had 5 of their kids taken away for, quote, not being properly socialized. So that wording specifically was like, wait a minute, they've never asked me this before. And then they also asked things like, what kind of extracurricular activities are your kids in? But to the point where it was like, if you didn't tell them something, it was like, it wasn't the right answer. Like, they're like, well, they're in something, right? What are they in? Oh, what they're in at church? We'll let that count for you. Like they had to mark down that the child was involved in something extracurricular or it was negative. Then they asked me, do you have any guns in your house? So that was pretty alarming to me, you know, thinking, what business do you have even knowing that, you know?
Yeah, that's your right to protect your family if you do have a gun or not. So that's none of their business.
Exactly. And too, all these questions were just kind of, they were presented in a way that was very much put me in a position where I felt like I was being interrogated. Which is not at all what you expect when you go to the doctor. And this is a doctor that my family's been going to for close to 5 years now. So I really didn't expect any surprises. You know, I've been sharing this story with friends just to kind of give them a heads up. And they've been like, oh, well, you need a new doctor and this and that. And I said, well, this was our doctor for this long. It's not like we tried a new, you know, just had a bad experience. And then, you know, they move on with the exam and I think, okay, that's over. This is crazy. I'm going to have to look into this. And my doctor comes in. That was the nurse asking us those questions. The doctor comes in and, you know, does the kind of normal routine, checks the kids. And my daughter, who, remember, she's almost 8 now, he asks her, are you a boy or a girl?
Wow.
Excuse me?
Yeah, I think I would be exceptionally angry.
What right do you have asking my child that? I was floored. I felt like in shock. It was weird because you think of people being in shock and like car accidents and things like that. But I just sat there like in shock, like this cannot be happening. Like, you know, and then he goes, what about your brother? Is he a boy or a girl? What about your mommy? And she's wearing a dress to the doctor's appointment. He goes, what about you? Do you wear dresses? What about your brother? Does he ever wear dresses?
Wow.
And
that's out of control.
It is so out of control. And it's all over the news. It's not like he can even pretend like this is something that he had no idea about. You know, we've got these little kids that are 4 that parents are condoning their choice to be a different gender. It's like, would you do that if they said, I want to be a unicorn? But we confronted our doctor on this. My husband did. There's actually like a web portal that you can go to and put in messages and things like that to communicate with your doctor. And he had messaged him saying, you know, my daughter told me that you had asked this question if she was a boy or a girl. I do not think that is appropriate at all. What would ever give you the idea that that was an okay question? And the doctor's response to this really, really just got me upset because his response was, I ask silly questions to build rapport with my patients.
Yeah, like he asked that at the beginning of the doctor's meeting instead of the end.
Well, he asked it, you know, if you're building a rapport, you're going to, yeah, exactly, do that at the beginning of a doctor's office, right? You're going to build rapport up. That way they don't feel as funny when you're asking them to stick out their tongue and put things in their ears and whatnot. But he asked it at dead last, at the very, very end. And it was really bizarre because he asked it almost in a way where it was like he didn't want to ask it, but he had to get through it. And after the fact, he was really reassuring, like, your kids are good, your kids are good, your kids are good. You have healthy kids, don't worry about anything. So he, you know, his response was just, oh, it was a silly question. I also did speak with the office manager at the doctor's office. And her response to me was, we ask all the kids that. And I confronted her on that. And I said, no, you don't. We've been there for 5 years and we've never been asked that questions before. And I said, is this something new that is a requirement in your offices? And she said, oh, I wouldn't know anything about that. I'm not a doctor, but I'm pretty sure all the doctors ask that question. So, I mean, as a parent, it's really upsetting to not only have an experience like that, but you can't even get to the bottom of why it's going on because all you're getting is lies left and right.
So, yeah, this is probably a new part of the Obamacare. Some of these questions are rolling out. Some of the typical stuff that they ask veterans as well. Do you have guns or not? And then they come in and, you know, kick them off their health care and this and that. Right. So, that's amazing the way that they're pushing this whole transgender lifestyle, especially at such a young age now. You know, they have these MTV shows, all these different things. And it's good to see that you're coming out, you're telling the story and kind of helping inform a lot of these other parents so they can look for these signs when they go to the doctor as well.
Yes, definitely. The biggest takeaway I've gotten from this, honestly, is just, you never know where this is going to come from. You never know where you're going to have someone breach your rights as a parent. And so now more than ever, we just have to really be on guard and on the lookout every possible place, even the places that for us used to be safe havens, which is really scary.
And you're also telling me too, that there was another family who homeschooled their children and they had their kids taken as well, right?
Yeah. Some friends that are homeschoolers, they actually had a friend of theirs, pretty much they were dropping off some food at their house. And this friend from church, nonetheless, who was dropping off food at their house, saw that the house was messy, which of course it would be messy. Mom's in the hospital. We know the moms do a lot of the cleaning. So mom was in the hospital and the older kids were keeping, you know, an eye on the little ones, and dad was at work and he was going to be home later that evening. And that woman just didn't like, you know, that wasn't her idea of what should be happening. And so instead of going to the parent, she went right to CPS, and CPS was able to get a judge to sign off on an immediate evacuation of all of those children.
It's amazing the world we live in where
so sad.
People just go and do these things. I mean, left and right, we're seeing homeschoolers being attacked. We're seeing these kids being asked these crazy questions. And this is just the world that we're living in now. But the best thing that we can do is inform one another and help each other fight this stuff with information. So I just want to say thank you, Jessica, for taking time out of your morning to come out here and talk to us and share your story.
Thank you, Joe. I really appreciate it.
All right. Have a good day.
You too.
And we are live, ladies and gentlemen, in overdrive here on the weekday syndicated radio transmission, normally 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., but we're going to go live until the bottom of the hour today, so 3.5 hours of transmission. Joe Biggs is doing a great job going through the Real Alex Jones Twitters and his Twitter. That way we get these contacts from parents to humanize what's happening. We showed you the articles where from Virginia to California, from Texas to Michigan, they're going into 5-, 6-, 7-year-olds and just doing whole classes on, you could be a boy, you could be a girl, and your parents can't stop you. Incredible sexualization. Screwing with these kids hardcore. There's always been people that environmentally or naturally, a very low percentage, that end up thinking they're the other sex, and whatever, live and let live as an adult, do what you want. This is the sexualization of children. And the UN's pushing to legalize pedophilia. They're trying to lower the age down to like age 10 or 12 in areas of Europe. And saying, parents, you can't stop your 10-year-old son or daughter from having sex with some guy at the park. That's where all this goes. And there is a cold war going on against Christians and against homeschoolers and others by many of these CPS jurisdictions. That's why CPS has about a 55% national turnover, because good people go to college to be social workers. They get in and they find out it's horrible. So let's be clear. This is a top-down deal. Most social workers that help old people and stuff that I've run into are really loving, caring people. But there are child predators and others that get into the CPS, and then the good people get out because the predators have taken over, and they really are deviant, and they want to teach this. And the doctors, of course, are uncomfortable, because I can actually pull up articles where the doctors are ordered to ask about the guns. That's been going on for 10 years. But under Obamacare, if you take Medicare or Medicaid, and of course, they shouldn't even be following this. Why are we following unconstitutional orders? It's indentured servitude to make you follow these federal policies. But why do we have Michelle Obama telling our kids what to eat in school? And if school districts remove the food, the feds fine them. I mean, we're not supposed to be top down with big sis and big brother telling us what to do. We're not supposed to have the NSA warrantlessly spying on us. But in many of these jurisdictions that are following these orders, they do indeed ask children about their gender and how they identify to put it to database. Now they're giving 15-year-olds sex changes here in the U.S. with taxpayer money. They want to make it for 10-year-olds. They want to convince your 10-year-old to go have their genitals altered. Oregon allowing 15-year-olds to get state-subsidized sex change operations. So this is social engineering on a mass scale. It's not a revolution of people that have been downtrodden getting their new freedoms. It's only empowered revolutions that end the basic biological code of the species. The University of A&M at College Station has developed systems to sterilize through the process, different processes, during biological processes, to sterilize fire ants, to confuse them sexually with pheromones. The gay bomb was produced by the Pentagon. You can just type in Pentagon produced gay bomb that you can spray on men, and then it makes them attracted to other men. I mean, they are manipulating our biology. Upwards of half the amphibians are now bisexual just from the chemicals that are running off. This is just a fact. And then as the change starts, as we're being killed, as we're being euthanized genetically, as we're being put to sleep genetically, sexually, they then say, oh, everyone suddenly doesn't know what sex they are. Be nice, be friendly. And we're like, oh, okay, sure. You live your own life. I'm not obsessed with it. Oh, really? You're going to pay for people to have sex changes? Oh, well, government's too big. I mean, can I pay for somebody that wants to, you know, have their nose job too? Or a facelift? And then next it's, oh, we're going to teach your kids to be tolerant. All right. Yeah, we're going to tell your six-year-old, you know, how to put a condom on a banana. It's about a power grab. Plain and simple. So we're going to get this lady on. Great job, Joe Biggs. Send us, you know, your comments, your stories, any documentation, the information you have to Real Alex Jones on Twitter, also at Rambo Biggs on Twitter, and to the other great reporters like Jakari Jackson and Leanne McAdoo and so many others, David Knight, Darren McBreen, others, so they can follow up on the story and get more and more of these breaking news stories out outside of the syndicated radio show and the nightly news, because stuff's moving too fast. And in closing, that's why it's not imperative, it's essential that you don't take this broadcast for granted, that I don't either. That's why you see me shoot reports at night or come in on Saturdays, and I do reports that go on Infowars.com. It's because I'm like, whoa, this is too important. I need to not just sit here like a frog in the pot and boiling. I need to respond. And so I need to hire a couple more reporters, a couple more videographers, editors. We need more equipment. We need to be able to send people around the country. We need to be able to make more films, and we can't do that without your support. So spreading the word wakes people up. They also become listeners and support our sponsors and buy our products that we fund the operation with. And it's all the best water filters, the lowest price that you need with what's in the water table, the glyphosates, the fluoride, the chemicals, the dead bacteria, the living bacteria. It's non-GMO, high-quality seeds at the lowest prices. I went out and made deals with the biggest producers to bring you the widest selection at the lowest price. These are great deals. Books, videos, T-shirts, free shipping in the month of July. All of this makes what we're doing possible, and I'm going up against some powerfully rich enemies who are a lot bigger than us. But you know what? We've got a sling. We've got a rock. We've got the truth. We've got the will. We've got what it takes. I mean, I know how to just... My daughter threw her goggles up in a tree a few weeks ago when we were going back down, just playing to the green belt, and she threw them way up the top of a tree. And I just had a bottle of water in my hand, and it was just way up in the tree, probably 30 feet up in the tree, because it was goggles. She could sling them up really high. And I just said, watch this. Boom. Didn't think through it. Knocked it perfectly out, up under it, making it come down. And when I, with a gun or a rock, when I was a kid with squirrels, I could just kill squirrels and rabbits all day and take them home and actually cook them, as if I killed something, I had to eat it. And other kids couldn't do that because I could just flip a switch and do it. And anytime I hesitate, I can't do it. I don't want to say use the force, but it basically is getting in the zone. We can politically, folks, take action and have the will. Our enemies have will, and they're overrunning us and pissing on us, basically. I mean, they are rubbing our face in it. They are dominating us. Melissa Harris Perry says your kids belong to us. They're taking kids age 11 because their parents are an hour late. You know, I get home at 6 and they play basketball in the backyard because the kid can't find the spare key. That happened to me many times, that somebody didn't put the spare key back and I was locked out. And the neighbors but invite me over for coffee or whatever, or for a, you know, a soda. I mean, I would stay out till 10 at night during the summer running around when I was 8 years old. I would go camp out when I was 10 years old, you know, in the woods by the park. And, you know, it was just the cops would drive by and say, and knew it was kids camping. And I grew up on the edge of Dallas. I mean, we are so domesticated. We are so pathetic. And it's just the beginning of the end of humanity. As we're absorbed into computers, our IQs drop, we can't communicate, we lose our association with others. There's a sickness on the people, and I want to break it. I want to stop it. I don't want to go into this, but you've got to recognize how bad it is. All of you that serve the evil, you think you're part of the system. You're not. You're being destroyed. You're losing your humanity, too. This is real. They put gender benders in the damn water. Here's Melissa Harris Perry with her cult look in her eyes that sounds good. It takes a village. Yeah, but don't have your neighbors actually spank your kid or actually take you home. No, call the police on them. That's their new village. Everything is twisted. Here it is.
We haven't had a very collective notion of these are our children. So part of it is we have to break through our kind of private idea that kids belong to their parents or kids belong to their families and recognize that kids belong to whole communities. Once it's everybody's responsibility and not just the households, then we start making better investments.
Yeah, they used to call it mind your own business, and adults talking to your seven-year-old about sex. They called it pedo behavior. But what it is that, I mean, when I went and had my kids, every time at a major hospital, I knew the doctor, they came in and said, sir, we took this file downstairs. And as soon as I left, they asked my wife if I beat her or if we had enough money to put it in the file to take the kids. They don't tell women, if you got any marijuana in your system, they're going to take your kid from you. All these federalized bureaucracies are there to prey on you. Get that through your head. Make no mistake. And it's all sold for a greater good, so the minions think they're doing good. No, it's not for a greater good.